that thing's legit, dude. Moises, the production value keeps going up. What the fuck?
You can't hide.
Oh, wait. Now it's like.
Yeah, it's in basic solution.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this first thing I do is assign oxidation numbers, right? So this is aluminum, zero. It's in the delta state. Three oxygens, two minus each, six overall, right? Yeah. So this makes its nitrogen a 5+ because we have an overall charge of 1. So let's go on to this side. We have 4H+, each one's +1, 4+. Also four oxygens, each one's 2-, so 8- overall. That gives us a total charge of these together. It's 4-, but we have an overall minus charge here, so this is going to 3+. Yes?
Chemistry. Yes, come on.
Okay.
Yeah. You're good. Yeah.
Now this NH3, this is a +3, and this is a -3. Yes. Okay. So now, let's see what got oxidized with carbon. Clearly, the aluminum got oxidized by 3 electrons.
Yep.
Yes. And the nitrogen got reduced by 2 electrons.
No, you gotta
by, seven.
If you balance the, let's see.
This
Eight electrons,
yeah. So it's
5 to 3 electrons.
Yeah. So
let's 5 to negative. I did that mistake on the test, so.
5 to -3.
Yeah, yeah. If you go to the negative, if you cross the boundary from 0 to the negative, it's, you have to add them still, right?
Yeah. Right.
I think I went too fast. I was like, it's 5. You know, like,
let's go.
Yeah, I was like, yeah.
So let's write our happy reactions.
It's reduction, so it goes in the left. Yeah. With it.
Yeah. Yeah. You sure?
Mm-hmm.
Reduction,
right? Because it's added, then it gets more negative on the right. So, yeah. So, the.
Man, you told me the other opposite, man.
I'm looking at it right now.
You move
now,
your head the wrong way. It's the light.
Am I writing big enough for you guys?
Is that big enough for now?
Is that big enough for now?
Sorry, there's like a really big there right where you're writing. Could you write a little bigger? Is that okay?
It's bigger, you said?
A little bigger?
Yeah, that's fine.
So, or if you move your head, the glare
off? Wait.
Not to mention this, a lot of people read it.
So, NH3- + ATE goes to NH3. Okay. U. This is also AQ. Okay. Let's write our oxidation. Do you guys want to balance the oxygens now, or do you just want to?
Write it all out.
Write it all out first, okay. So let's do the oxidation part. And that's going to be Al solid go to. And we said 3 electrons, correct? Yes. 3E-. Balance the oxygens and hydrogens on this side. So now on this side we're missing 3 O's, so we add 3 waters. Right. Cool. Then we have a total of 9 H+'s and 0 here, so we add 9 H+'s to this side. Okay. Now for the bottom, we see that we have 4 missing oxygens on this side, so we're going to add 4 H2Os. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now we have 8 H's here, but 4 here, so we got to add another 4 to this side. That's +4H+. All right. So now we see the electrons are unbalanced, so we got to multiply by the least common multiple, so 8 and 3, I think it's 24, is it?
Yeah.
So multiply this by 3 and multiply this by 4.
8. Multiply by
8. 8, yeah. Sorry, 8. So let's distribute that 3 in. We get 27h plus 3 and 3 minus. It'd be nice to have a chair. I
can sit. You want a chair? Like a rolly chair.
Yeah, exactly.
Little skateboard.
I'm too tall. I'm too tall for this board. Alright, 3 and h3.
That's the perfect height. It's great.
Plus 9h2o.
It's like pointing out.
Alright. So that's the first. Let me just write it down. This is the reduction we did. No, oxygen. Reduction. Yes. Mm-hmm. And then we can do the oxidation one. And then we have 2 H2Os plus 8 aluminums, 24 electrons. Alright. Plus 8 aluminum hydroxides. Plus 32 H pluses.
So the numbers get kind of out of hand sometimes, but
you get some pretty big numbers, right?
It's no biggie though, right?
Alright, so now we're just gonna simply combine and cancel. So the electrons are gone, right? And now I have 27 H pluses here. 27 minus 32 is
5.
I'm gonna have 5 H plus here. I'm just gonna write it for now. And then we'll combine everything at the end. 32 minus 9, or 9 minus 32 is
13.
9 minus 32?
Yeah,
13.
No, sorry, 23.
Yeah. Like, wait, what? 23 H2O. And that's about all you cancel, right? So now we're just gonna combine it in one big equation. Should I write it in the bottom or should I erase some of the top and do it on the top?
What
do
you use? Bottom.
The bottom's fine?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know, maybe yes. I can get on my knees now, so
he's basically asking, please don't make me go.
23 H2O plus 8 aluminum goes to 3 NH3 plus 8 AlOH 4 plus 5 plus. So now, if they were asking us for basic, for acidic, this would be complete, right? But that's for basic. So for every H plus we see, we're adding that same amount of hydroxides to both sides, yeah. So we have 5 H plus on this side, so we're gonna add 5 hydroxides to both sides. Did I subtract that right? 4, yeah.
Oh, sorry.
27 and 32.
Make sure.
It's 5. Should be 5.
Yeah. Okay. So plus 5OH plus 5OH.
Nice.
Yeah?
That's good, dude.
So now we're combining, since we add the OH now, we're just combining the loose H plus with the 5OHs to get water, right? So we're going to have 5 waters on this side. I'm just going to write this as 5H2O. I'm not going to write another line because then I'll run out of space. So now, after I combine my OH with my Hs, I'm simply just subtracting the waters for that on both sides. So 5 minus 23. So now I'm going to have 5OH minus plus 3NO3. And 5 minus 23 is 18. Plus 18H2O plus 8Al. Goes to 3NH3 plus 8AlOH4, and that's it. Any questions on the process?
Expect one of these for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Any questions? Comments? Concerns? No?
Cool. Yeah, hopefully you guys have been practicing that.
Yeah, this is most likely to show up on the back of your test, just to give you the heads up. One of these for sure. So, yeah, no questions then?
Sweet.
Cool. Let's go on to the next one. Well, I mean, should we check it, or are you guys?
Yeah.
Check it?
Yeah.
Okay. So we have five O's, nine O's, it's 14. Oh, man, it's a big number. Let me get my calculator. hold up. Let's just check it on the other thing. Because that's a lot to check. I'm pretty lazy.
Eight aluminum.
So eight aluminums, yes.
5
OHs, yeah. Yes. 18 waters, yes. 3 and a 3s, yes. Yeah, that's good.
We got it right, yeah.
I have a question. Okay, so we learned in class a couple weeks ago that the charges are also supposed to balance out.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you look on this side, it's 8 negatives, but then on the other side, there's nothing.
I think
you missed
something.
That's because the
OH minus
8 LUH is minus.
The
last
something?
One
is
minus.
Oh, did I miss
something?
That's
just
at the very bottom.
The
8 LUH.
Yeah,
that's
a
minus.
Yeah, sorry.
Okay,
I must have missed it. Yeah, I must have missed
the
negative somewhere.
No, that's fine. Okay, thanks.
Yeah.
Cool. Cool. Good. Yeah. Alright.
That's cool.
I like this one.
Yeah.
This one's fun.
This is okay. Nice.
You're also going to get one like this.
Yeah.
So
definitely.
Expect one like the previous one we just did. Also this. Just so we'll do it in order really quick. They want us to identify the metals, right? They tell us that the left is the what? Anode, right?
Yeah.
And the right's the cathode. Okay, so that's important. So we
is
need
that,
it. We need
is it.
Is
it always going to be that way?
Not necessarily.
Okay.
Yeah, sometimes it'll actually be flipped intentionally to mess you up. Yeah.
But also with the cell notation, you always write the cathode on the left.
Anode's on the left. Yeah.
Anode's, oh, okay.
Yeah.
So cell notation.
With cell notation, that's pretty fixed. Yeah.
Okay.
But in terms of the diagram, no, I've seen it intentionally done the opposite way. Cool. All right, so let's get started. Let's do it. So because they told us that the anode is the one on the left, that tells us a lot because we know that that anodes are oxidized, right?
Yeah.
And that we know that the cathodes are reduced. Anoxin and red cat, yeah. And they tell us we have aluminum and we have magnesium. So at this point, we would have to consult the chart you're going to get in the back of the test, because you need to figure out which one is going to get oxidized and which one's going to get reduced. So on the side here, I'll do that for us. I'm going to write the half reactions that you would have. Notice that these are reduction potential. So
this will be given on the chart?
It'll be given to you like this, exactly.
Oh, okay.
How I'm writing. Yeah.
Yeah,
is it EV? I think it's EV, right?
Yeah, it's electric.
Yeah,
EV.
Yeah.
Like the Pokemon?
Like the Pokemon, yeah.
I don't know if you guys got that reference.
It'll be magnesium.
I forgot about EV.
If not, you guys are late.
Okay.
Yeah, E is
so,
circle V, which is standard.
Yeah, these are E cell potential, or these are called reduction potentials, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's important that we recognize their proximity to each other. So because this is a more negative number, right? That means it's more likely to be what?
Oxidized.
Okay.
Yeah.
So remember that if we're going up, we get more positive, and we're more likely to be reduced that way.
Oh, right.
And if we're negative, we're more likely to be oxidized.
Yeah. Make sure you guys know that. There's going to be a lot of questions.
Yeah.
On the,
and
on the
I prefer
choice.
You not to actually remember it by placement.
Mm-hmm.
Know it by the number value.
Yeah.
Because I've seen before East like reduction charts juxtaposed, so like they're all flipped and everything. So because it's mean, yeah, but because it's like, so look at the value of the E cell, okay? So because this one is more negative, that's going to be our one that's oxidized. Cool. And the one that's this one's a little bit less negative, meaning it's more positive, so it's going to be the one that's reduced. Cool. Okay, so that means then on the left, just quickly. We said the one on the left is the anode, so it's being oxidized.
Right.
So it looks like it's going to be solid
magnesium.
Mm-hmm. Is that cool? So metal A, we're ready here, is magnesium. We were able to figure that out because of the potential.
Right.
This one here must be aluminum.
Yep.
Now, this is cool because we actually know that it comes in a solid. Otherwise, we'd have to use some sort of inert metal, like graphite, platinum. All right, because. So we don't in our E cell notation, it's just going to be solid magnesium, solid aluminum. Cool. All right. Okay. So what's next? We need to figure out what do they want? The flow of electrons and so on? Yeah, so then, okay, the flow of electrons always goes in alphabetical order. A to C, A to C, yeah? So alphabetical order. So electrons are going from anode to cathode.
For real?
Alphabetical order.
Yeah, it's going from anode to cathode. Unless it's electrolysis.
Unless it's electrode.
Yeah, electrolysis.
Yeah, so this, that's true.
Flows from the anode to the cathode.
Yeah, this is a voltaic cell, right? And it stated in the beginning, right? Yeah.
And they would tell us that. Okay.
Yeah.
There's no electrolytic cell in the other.
They don't really give you a diagram, but you could do it. Yeah. It would, the flow of electrons would just go which way?
The other way.
The other way, right? And you would have to have a battery up at the top for propelling that. Yeah. But we don't have that. We have a voltaic cell. I would expect a voltaic cell, to be honest, but maybe study some, you know, electrolytic.
What is it like? Just like one of the multiple choice problems is going to be.
Yeah.
Electrolytic is just the opposite of voltaic.
Yeah, it's just a little complicated sometimes when it comes to the diagrams. So you're likely to see a voltaic. Okay, so that means that if we're going to calculate the E cell for this, we actually need to flip the one that's oxidized, right? So we're going to flip this one. It's going to become positive. Is that cool? So I don't really care about that one. I care about magnesium converting to this. So we're going to have that, two electrons, plus Mg, 2 plus. So you're right. I probably should put a solid here just to be super clear.
And then balance out the electrons.
Cool. Nice. So now we're going to calculate E cell. I can do it using that, or here, I'll erase it.
So you can balance the electrons first.
We do, yeah, because we have a 3 here and a 2 here.
Well, 6.
So we're going to put a 2. We're going to put a 3. Notice that I'm not going to affect the, I put the parentheses purposely around this, not about that.
You don't need to multiply.
Right? We don't multiply the E cell number. You do not do that at all, because this value is independent of the amount that you have. It's going to be this amount. Okay. Okay. I mean, that changes when the concentrations are different between each other, but we'll get to that later. Okay, so our overall equation is going to be, what was this value? Did I write? It was
-2.
It's going to be positive 2.37 now, right?
Oh yeah.
EVs, because I flipped the sign.
Yeah.
Yeah. You just.
So then E cell is just the combined of that. That would just be 2.37 minus 1.66. So what is that?
That's 0.71.
0.71 EV. Notice that it's positive, which is good, because it's a voltaic cell. It needs to be spontaneous. It needs to be positive. If you get a negative number, you did something wrong. If they tell you it's a voltaic cell and you get a negative number, it's wrong. Mm-hmm. Cool. So we calculated E cell. We balanced the electrons. So like, let's say we were solving for delta G, right? For delta G, it would be delta G is equal to, is it negative NFE?
Yeah, negative NFE, E of the cell.
So the N would be
okay.
6.
So because we balanced this with the coefficients, the N in this case is going to be 6 electrons. So that N would be 6.
Right.
Cool? So that's why it's useful to balance them. It doesn't actually give you a different value for E cell. But it does help you with this, getting N, okay? Mm-hmm. So that's why you do it, okay? So just keeping that in mind. This isn't about that question, but that's how we would do this.
So electrolytics will always be negative?
Yes, Orly asked, will it be negative for electrolytic? And that's true, right? Because it's a non-spontaneous process that's driven by a battery, an external source. Okay, so that means then floating in here, I have magnesium ions, right? And here I have aluminum ions. Great. I got my salt bridge. We would have any kind of, like, usually they put like potassium nitrate or something like that. Some sort of like, you know, like thick, something that's filled with, basically positive and negative ions. Yeah. Okay. So what would be my notation, my cell notation? It would be the solid, right? Mg, followed by the ions in the solution. That'd be Mg2+. A double line for the salt bridge. We'd have aluminum 3+, and then aluminum. Cool.
Axis for that?
Yep.
I have a quick question. Okay, so if it was the fact that both of them were ions, how exactly would you write the cell percentage for adding on like platinum?
It's super easy. All you do is you're gonna have a platinum here instead.
Yeah.
And then you're still going to have the ions floating around, like you said, right? Yeah.
There's actually an example in this chapter.
We're going to get to it for sure. Yeah, there's going to be. It's just a slightly different example. Cool. So I think we covered everything, we covered the shorthand, we labeled everything, so I think we're good. Yeah? Nice. So that's it. Yeah? Good. All right, we can go home now. Go, you go ahead. All right. So I practice with Esau, right?
Yes. Yeah,
you can do the next two. I'll do the seven, I guess.
No, never mind. Alright, so I'll take 7 for this reaction, blah, blah, blah. Calculate the voltage produced by this reaction under standard conditions at 25 degrees Celsius. Cool. So, we see that tin gets oxidized, right? And silver gets reduced.
Yep.
Now we need simply the...
I'm learning it right now.
Oh, you got the values? We just need the values of the tin and the Ag in terms of reduction potentials, but tin value needs to be flipped because it's being oxidized. So we're going to flip that value once we get it.
Once I hurry up.
No, that's going to work.
2+, 2+.
Everything's balanced here too, right?
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
It
is. Good.
Oh, it is bounced for you. Okay.
Yeah, it's
bounced. So then,
cool.
Yeah, that's 14. -0.14. Yeah.
Okay. And do you have it written as a reduction potential?
They're all both reductions. Cool. Yeah. Yeah.
So we have Sn 2+ goes to Sn solid plus 2e, and now I'm going to go to Ag plus. They're both. You said they're both written as reduction potential?
Yeah, I wrote them both as reduction. So the other one should be 0.8.
How come the electrons and wins?
Oh, I'm just dumb, I guess. I should put an electron there. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you assume that it's a forward reaction then?
Oh, yes.
Write it all like that?
Yeah.
Okay. So right now, this value is 0.4 volts, and that one is 0.8. Right. Okay. So they're both written in reduction. Sorry, it's very small writing. I'm sorry about that. Oh. I'll take note of that for the next line I write. So we both noticed that they're both in reduction form, right? But we know that both things can be reduced. And we look to the chart and say, tin is more negative, so it's going to be oxidized. So we're going to flip this one.
Actually, I think the electron should be on the left of that.
They're both on the same side, so like different sides. So like, I just keep on the right.
You're sorry about that. Yeah.
So we need to flip this tin because we know that tin's going to be the one that's doing the oxidization, right? That's even a word. So we're going to have to flip this. Does everyone see why, though? Yeah?
Yes,
it's because this likes to reduce things more than silver does. So let's do that. But before that, let's just balance it, right? 2 electrons here, so multiply by 2. Okay, so let's flip this and combine. Have 2e plus.
Doesn't matter what tin will go with, it will be the reducing agent?
No, it does matter. It does matter.
Okay.
So depending on, let's say this was something lower,
right?
Than negative, let's say it was like negative 16,
mm-hmm.
Tin would actually be being reduced and the other one would be being oxidized.
Right, right, right.
So it just depends on the values.
Gotcha.
So.
Thanks.
Yeah. Good question. I
go to Sn2+. Plus.
And we have this. If you have the values like that, yeah, but it's always good to double check.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, that's fine. We have 2Ag.
And this was considering that it's all at standard. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, standard. So, standard condition. Oh, man, I'm writing small again, aren't I?
Zero.
So let's combine them. We're going to have electrons cancel. Have Sn solid plus 2Ag plus yields Sn 2 plus 2Ag solid. And then we have a total of 0.94 electron volts. And that's the answer.
Nice.
Yeah.
how does that change? Will they give us that problem?
I don't. It's, so you're saying in the equation it's wrong? Like,
oh, no.
How it's
like if the equation is wrong and they're like, okay, well, which one should be?
Oh yeah, they will give you that actually. They will tell you, based off this reaction, what should be the correct oxidizing and reducing agents. So yeah, that's they will do that. But they'll give you the right. They won't give you the full combined reaction like we did. They'll give you the half reactions. So
okay.
they'll give you these.
So they won't give you that. Okay.
No, they won't give you this full one because here you can tell that this one gets oxidized, but they
yeah.
will give you these and
yeah.
they will ask you which
okay.
one's the oxidizing or reducing agent. So yeah, they will. But yeah, no questions on this?
No.
Cool. So let's move on.
The next one's kind of subtle. Do it.
Are you saying I'm not good enough? No, kidding.
On the spot, you're like,
no worries. Take it.
All right. This one's good. This one's actually pretty decent. So, we're given some element. I don't know what the name of that would be. And we're trying to figure out what its reduction potential is. So now we're going to be working backwards, right? So we're given the E cell. We're going to find out what it is. Yeah. So the thing is that the way Fenton probably taught it was to flip the sign of the oxidation number and add them up, right?
Yeah.
It kind of falls short here because there is a general equation to solve for E cell in which you you just subtract the cathode. It's anode minus cathode. But in Fenton's way, you just add them. So I'll show you the algebra. It's kind of weird. Yeah. So in this particular case, we're given that this is E cell, right? And just to make sure, this right here is the anode, and this is the cathode, right?
Right.
So then this is being oxidized, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we need an equation in which this is being oxidized, but that is not it. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Do you see where it's kind of weird?
Yeah.
So whatever value we get, we're gonna have to like flip it. Do you see what I'm saying? So okay, so this is gonna. What we want actually is to find the because in our actual E cell equation, the value was ln plus
ln
ln the natural log. And then we also have copper. So because I grabbed it from the book for copper. For copper, we have this. You'll be able to figure this out. Also note, this is copper 2.
Yeah.
Right?
It's different
than copper 1, okay? Yeah, so this is for the reduction potential for copper is Cu 2 plus 2 electrons gives you that. And the value here is 0.34. Cool.
And they'll give us that?
Oh, you're gonna have a, you know, like that giant chart with everything, like with the arrows and everything.
Yeah.
It'll be stapled to the back of your test. Yeah.
There's no words on it. No stronger oxidizing agent.
No. Yeah. Nothing. It'll just be a chart. Yeah.
Just
so yeah, you have to kind of know it. Yeah.
Well, we have a cheat sheet.
You do have that,
yeah.
I guess. Yeah. Where you get
it?
It's super easy.
Yeah.
Don't waste time on your cheat sheet on
in the space, yeah.
Writing every single stuff.
Yeah.
Just
put it on the back.
Okay. So the way Fenton would like us to do it, right? Is to add these up and then get our number, so, right? But that falls flat though because that wouldn't be representative of the value of the reduction potential. That would be the oxidation potential. Did you catch that?
Yeah. But
yeah.
Then couldn't you just flip the sign?
Yes. But I'm trying to bring that. I'm trying to bring that to your attention.
Wait, say that again.
So, the way Fenton has you do it is get the reduction potential and the oxidation potential and add them up.
Yeah.
Yes. Right. This is asking for the reduction potential. So we're going to have to get the value and then reverse the sign.
Okay.
I'm just bringing that to your attention. Cool? Yep. Another way to do this is super simple. It's the actual formula way, which is E cell. I don't even do it this way, so I don't even like it either. So E cathode minus E anode. See that? Now, in this particular equation, this is the equation for reduction potentials. So there's no sign flipping. You just plug in the values. That's easy. So I'm bringing this to your attention because I know the way that Fenton teaches it,
mm-hmm.
and it kind of makes this question hard. Otherwise, 9 out of 10 times, his method is easy, and it works. But this is like the weakness to that version, okay? So that would be, we're solving for this one, which would be the anode, right? So I gotta isolate the anode, bring this over. So that'd be E anode. Go. Our E of our cathode, well, that's given to us, 0.34, right? So that's 0.34 minus E of the cell, which is 0.68. Right? And then whatever that is, I think it's just itself halved, right? So that means E of the anode is negative 0.34. So most of the time, this equation is not very good. It is helpful in this case. Cool. So if they're asking for reduction potentials within the equation and they give you E cell, this might be a good one to use, just to limit the confusion. Otherwise, like we said, you would just, do you want to see it the other way? Like, do you want to see it the way the, I would if do it the Fensimer? Okay. Let's do that really quick.
And then for the cathode or the oxidizing potential.
Yeah, the equation just changes, right? Mm-hmm. So it would just be this, but plus, right?
Yeah.
It would be E cat plus E N, right? But you'd have to like flip within it, right?
Yeah.
So once you solve it, you're gonna have to flip the sign.
Yeah.
So, yes. Oh, you'll be given it in the back of the in your back of your test.
Yeah, you have all those numbers.
Yeah, you're gonna get a big old list. So we've been pulling them out because on all these questions it says refer to appendix. Yeah, so instead of flipping to the appendix, we're just showing it.
You have that flow chart.
Yeah, so this is how the way you would do it the other way. We would solve for this by just flipping this over. So that'd be E cell, E cap, equals E, E anode. And that would just be the positive value, 0.68 minus 0.34, which was right there, 0.34, right, given to us, right there. But do you see how we got the wrong value?
Why again do you flip the?
Because.
Oh, the.
When you use this equation, this right here is a oxy potential.
Mm.
Not a reduction potential. Cool. That's the difference.
Yeah.
So, cool. So do you guys understand what's going on? Yeah. So we have to flip it. This is for oxy, right? So for reduction, negative 0.34.
Gotcha.
Cool. Nice. I'm glad. So
here's no HG.
I think that's pretty much it. Yeah. So is that what's up?
Oh no. That's the next one.
I think they have one of the book.
Oh, they don't have it?
In their book? Unless I'm blind.
I think it's because you have the old book, bro.
Yeah, the old book. It's still the best one.
Yeah. Moises is like, he really likes the edition that's two editions old. he's like, it's good.
Number eight. So if we'll take cellulose. Use the reaction. Yeah, no, I know. I just I don't know the actual values because HG's not in my book, so I'm gonna have to use that one.
And mercury wasn't invented back then.
Calculate the voltage reaction for this reaction in certain conditions. Okay, cool. So let's do our handy dandy
notebook
half reactions, right? So let's see. SN 2 plus plus 2E goes to in this case it's going.
Yeah, it's a it's different one. So this one, yeah, I don't know. So it's E negative 15. So it's S.
And the mercury one, what is it?
Mercury? It is, it's a 2 plus, so it's 2 electrons, and, or it's actually 1 electron.
So HG?
HG 2 plus, plus 1 electron,
uh-huh.
Or maybe just 2 electron. HG subscript 2, 2 plus.
HG sub 2, okay.
Yeah. And then
goes
the
to
E, it's, yeah.
Goes to HG.
So the first HG is just HG without, yeah.
Oh, that's 2 plus.
Wow. Yeah, mercury is annoying. All yeah.
right. And this goes to HG 2 plus. HG 2, right?
HG subscript 2, 2 plus.
All right. So this one doesn't need this 2 there, right then?
No.
So now, what are the values for that?
90.9
and
negative 0.15. And then the HG that you have there has a 2 plus in front of it. So. On the left-hand side. Yeah.
This one too. Wow.
Yeah, as well.
Yeah.
Mercury's
so we got a balance of the electrons, right?
Two of them. Two of the AGs.
Not 21, right?
Oh, it's two. No, because they had to balance it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I was going to do that right now. Yeah. Balance it out right now. So I'm multiplying two.
So multiply by two. And I get SN2 plus goes to two.
But is originally.
For your half reaction, your HGs are not balanced.
Yeah, I'm balancing right now.
Balance your actual atoms before you balance your electrons, and in your bottom half reaction, your atoms are not balanced because there's one on one side and two on the other.
Just be a two that you said, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then times that entire thing by two.
And then
right.
Two E's.
Mm-hmm. You have a four then?
No, you're good. It's just two electrons transferred.
There's just
two electrons transferred. That's fine.
Okay.
Yeah. Because it goes from an HG to that.
So that's
going
to be 4 HG2.
Mercury is weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Plus 2 E yields.
Wait. So you don't have to multiply it then?
No.
Yeah, no, you don't. Mm. Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, it is weird.
It's just as it's given then.
It's already given too nicely.
So you don't multiply.
Mercury
is. I don't know. It's not my foot, so I can't really tell.
Yeah, you're good.
Sorry. Okay, so then let's just cancel. And we know that tin right now is going to be the one being doing the oxidizing, right? So we have to flip this tin.
Each one being.
Because right now it clearly gets oxidized. So we're flipping this value.
It's going to 0.15,
right? And this is fine, so let's add everything back up. So we have Xn2 plus 2 HG2 plus.
Oh, wait, the other one's negative, and then it becomes, it's positive, but it becomes negative.
Okay.
This is positive, so this becomes negative. It goes to H. 2 plus Xn.
Wait, so it was.
I guess this book in the prop S was positive, so it's going to turn to negative, because this is being oxidized, right? So we have to switch it. So that's why we get this negative here. I guess in the book it was written as a positive.
That one is being reduced.
No,
yeah.
SN's being oxidized.
We have the E's on the other
side. I see why they're confused. Okay. Because you wrote the electrons on the right side. Yeah,
sorry.
Sorry.
There it is,
yeah. Okay.
So now we're just going to add 0.5, negative 0.5 and 0.9, and we get E cell.
Okay, so the two E's for the mercury will be on the other side as well.
No. So all Moises did was write the first two.
Yeah, these are
the reduction
potentials.
Yeah.
So then
when I do that
the...
here, when I combine them,
mm-hmm.
I'm just going to cancel. I didn't write that stuff. You want me to show that stuff? I skipped it because I thought you guys knew that tin got oxidized. And when I write the other
mm-hmm.
half reactions, the electrons are going to cancel. But I don't know if you guys want me to show that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Is that fine?
Yeah.
Okay. So now that I add this up, I'm going to get 0.75, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, 0.75. And that's my answer for this one. Okay. So now part B is just calculating delta G. And we have a formula delta G is equal to negative N F E cell, right?
Yep.
So when we do part B, Faraday's constant is
96,500.
96,500
coulombs per mole of electron.
So we have 2 moles of electrons, right? Two.
Yep.
Two times 96,000, you said?
96,500.
500.
Yep.
All right, times this. And we get delta G of the reaction of the cell is what?
Your delta G at the end?
Yeah.
You get a negative 1.4 times 10 to the 5 joules. And it makes sense too, because delta G is negative, and we know when delta G is negative, we have a spontaneous reaction.
Right.
So our E cell should be positive, which it is. Our delta G is negative, which it is, right? So all of our things are pointing towards a spontaneous thing. So.
Does that make sense?
Cool.
Yeah. Yeah, sorry for the little misunderstanding.
Yeah, Mercury's funky.
Good?
Yeah.
So that form is important.
I mean, it's good that you're making the mistakes as well that
yeah.
we don't make them.
Yeah,
well.
Mercury's a little weird. I had that same problem last
yeah.
semester as well. I couldn't really tell why it got reduced, but yeah. guess, yeah. Is that good, though? Yeah. No questions?
So the electrons are on the same side?
Yeah, for this part.
Okay.
Those are both
these
reduction.
Are,
that's how you would see it on your chart. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then you would see that in this, your overall reaction thing gets oxidized, so that's why you flip it. Even here, you said this is the lesser number, has the less magnitude than this one, so this would be the one getting reduced, the one getting oxidized.
You would flip the first one, which will flip also the charge.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So when I flip this, I'm gonna cancel my electrons at the end. I just didn't show that step.
Right. Okay.
So,
which I should. Sorry about that.
There we go. It's pretty similar here.
Yeah.
Similar. We get to do a drawing as well, so we get some more practice in that. All right. So.
Write
the two half cell reactions. All they gave us was an equation.
Mm.
So let's break up the equation and let's do it that way. So this is a 3 plus oxidation number.
Yeah.
It's a 2 plus, but there's two of them. Here I got a plus 1 and a 3 plus. As easy as it gets.
But there's also two of them.
Yeah. So, yeah. I'll get something.
Yeah.
And there we go. So. What is that, titanium? Is that?
Yeah.
So titanium went from a 3 plus to a plus 1, so that's like reduction to me. Right? So that's reduction. And then this one here went from a 2 plus to a 3 plus, so that's oxidation. Great. So in your book, you're going to be given the reduction potential, so I'm going to write them the way you would see it.
Mm.
So
I'll go empty.
Yeah, please, just for chromium. Just for chromium, that's Cr.
You have
Cr2
plus. Plus E minus. Oh, yeah, it would give you 0.5 volts.
Volts?
Yeah. Well, it's going from chromium 2 plus 3 plus, so you just put the electrons.
Oh,
one
sorry,
electron.
Yeah. So 2 plus
to
2.
3 plus.
Oh, so this should be flipped.
Yeah, it should be flipped.
Got it.
Yeah, I guess in here they give it to you like that. So
Cr3 plus plus an electron?
Yeah, that's going to be.
Cr2 plus. So,
negative.
Jenna, you brought up recently that what would it look like if I didn't have, if I had ions only, right? This is that example. Because notice that when we got reduced, we're still in an ion form. So I'm going to need some platinum or some graphite in my drawing. Is that fine? So that's how you know. If you have a charge, that means then it doesn't exist as a solid. Okay? Cool. All right, so then for the other one, I'm going to have. That is that, going from a plus, 3 plus nuts, that'd be titanium, 3 plus, plus 2 electrons.
Yeah, and that's going to give
goes
you...
Goes to Ti, 1 plus.
Oh, it's Ti?
Titanium,
oh.
Yeah. So, what's the value for this one?
Negative 50.
The negative 50. This is how you would see it in the...
In the book, yeah.
In the book, negative 50. We're solving for this one. So we'll put a question mark. Cool. We're given the E cell. That's equal to E cell.
That was thallium.
Thallium?
Thallium.
T-L?
Yeah, it's T. No idea, bro.
Thank you.
The atomic number's over like 50. I'm like, no, yeah. So, okay. So then we're almost done. Write the two half cell reactions. We're almost there because the thallium is getting reduced. This is okay, right? Because chromium is being oxidized with the flipping.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah.
So then when our half reaction, it's going to be flipped. So that's going to be Cr2 plus yields Cr3 plus plus an electron. And thallium, it's weird. 3 plus. I plus. Great. We've got a balance, right? So I'm going to multiply this one by what? Just two.
Mm-hmm.
Just two, right? Great. And then my E cell, they want us to get that down here. So write the two half cell reactions. So then, just for the sake of not writing it again, so just be two, and two.
Okay.
Is that cool?
Yeah.
Nice. So then that's answer for A. Write the half cell reaction. So solving for E, I'm gonna use the method we did last time, right? It was cathode minus anode, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's gonna be E cell is equal to cat minus N.
That's the original.
That's the original equation. So That means I can solve for m by bringing it over. That means that my m So that's just going to be, what is that? Cathode, negative 0.5, right?
Would it be positive?
It's positive, you flipped it.
I flipped it earlier? Yeah, I'm saying, well, easy, I flipped this up, it's easy.
Or actually, no, you're using, never mind.
No, I'm using the reduction potential, right? So then, yeah, okay.
Oh, because you're finding it for just for the value. Because
you're using the reduction potential.
I'm using, if there's a minus in this equation, there's no flipping. No flipping, you're just done. You just grab the number, plug it in. If there's addition in here, I have to flip. Okay, but I don't like flipping, so.
Wouldn't it, I guess, be easier because we already see that one's oxidized, so I'm trying to find the one that's reduced. So like before we're trying to find the one that's oxidized, then we have to flip it and everything. Wouldn't it just be easier to use the other equation that we had because we're
maybe,
looking for the
probably.
Reduced one?
What I like to do almost every time is to avoid categorizing equations for specific criteria. What I'd prefer to do is have an equation that does everything and know how to move it around in such a way to solve the equation. So I'd like to, when you ask me how do I solve for E cell, I plug in this, and then I move my problem around to solve for it. You're probably right, yeah, you're probably right that method would work, but I don't like the Fenton method, particularly because you have to think about flipping and stuff like that. So that's the only reason why I don't use it. And I think it's a good thing that you have a different perspective, someone showing you different methods too. So. It's up to you though. If you feel more comfortable that way, I would totally do it that way. But, yeah, up to you. Just be aware of it because of the sign flip is crucial.
I like this, but yeah.
Yeah. So you really just plug and chug when you do it this way. Yeah. So, okay. So cathode was negative 0.5, right? Minus E cell, which was minus 1.19.
So.
What do we get? So what do we get? Is that negative 0.69?
1.69.
That's E of the anode. So super negative, yeah. Which is a good thing, right? Because when you put it in the equation, it makes it a really big positive,
it's
right?
It's actually positive 69, 0.69.
Is it?
Oh, that's good,
yeah. Why is it 0.69? Oh, did I plug it in wrong?
Yeah, it's the cathode minus.
That's why. Yeah. Oh, did I just plug it in wrong?
Yeah, you just plugged it in wrong. That's it.
Cathode in. Nice.
Yeah, you just put the cathode on the E cell part.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, I put the wrong one. Okay.
Yeah, it's just
the
standard. This is just.
But why is that the guess? Yeah.
You have E of the cell.
Cat minus two.
Yeah.
So E of the cell on this side. Right?
Yeah. That's what. That's why. Yeah. That's
it's
why.
E cell and anode right here.
Yeah.
I have a question.
I thought chromium would be the anode because it's being oxidized. Chromium being, yeah.
Okay, so.
Yeah, that's why I messed up, yeah.
Oh, okay.
He's got the
equation wrong.
Yeah. So then we're solving for the cathode.
Yeah.
So it'd be E cell.
It's
nice.
That's E
anode. Yeah, the reduction of
the cathode. Yeah.
There it is.
So then we just have to do 1.19 minus 0.5.
Which is 0.69, yeah.
1.19? Yeah.
Yeah.
Plus negative.
Plus, right? So it's a minus, yeah. Plus a minus 0.5.
Which is 0.69.
Yep. It equals E cap. Cool. All right, what's next? I think there's a little bit more.
Oh, yeah, you have to draw it out.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
we can
move that down.
0.69. Can you make sure they're like this?
Huh?
One goes so fast and it's not as cool. It's like simple. No.
Oh yeah, this chapter is very interesting. I like it.
Yeah. We kind of glaze the surface too, because there's like plating and stuff too that you don't even talk about.
Yeah.
It sucks. Yeah.
That's the cool stuff too.
Okay.
Did you guys go over?
Sketch the voltaic cell. Label the anode, cathode. Indicate the direction. Right. Jeez, we already erased everything. So it would have been really helpful to have.
Yeah.
What's my cathode?
Your anode is chromium.
It was chromium, so it's oxidized, so it's going to be chromium. All right, just write it.
Was it?
Yeah. 2 plus, Mentalium. 3 plus?
Because it got reduced, right? So, okay.
TL. All
right, a little salt bridge. turn. Boop. All right. So remember I was saying that we don't have any solids in this one, right?
Right.
So that means we need like platinum on both of these as our as our electrodes. What's gonna be?
It's just gonna be.
Every time I think platinum, I think Jenna.
Oh, is that like a meme now? Is that
Zen?
Whenever we talk about platinum,
everybody.
Like, oh yeah, Jenna.
He's like, is that right, Jenna?
So I'll put PT for these, okay? Okay, and then because it's your drawing, it's your own drawing, you can put it in the direction you want, right? So, unless you want to flip it, because you're a rebel, right? And you can just sit. So it's right through both of the electrons, right?
Oh,
Fenton, I'm really good. I know, the other way, you fuck it up and you get it wrong. It's like, okay, so I'm going to have both of the ions here, right? Both. So then that means I'll have the, we said anode, right? Yeah. So I'm going to have Cr2 plus and Cr3 plus hanging out inside. That's the whole reason we have the bar here, platinum, right? And here, the same business, I'm going to have the Ti3 plus, Ti...
Plus.
Was it just plus, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tl.
Oh, was it L?
No, L.
That's no way an L. Is that,
that
is
was
that,
L.
That's
an L.
That was
an L.
That's why it was thallium.
That's why we
who does their L's like that though, bro? Like who does?
No,
it's
not.
It
looks
like
it. Look down there. The Br2L.
That's I.
That's an I though, but
no, the L,
L.
The liquid. The liquid.
Is that the L liquid?
Okay. Are you telling me that that's an L, but that's an I? Look how similar
that
is.
That's the same.
You've been lied to.
Look how seriously.
You lied to us.
No, honestly, that looks like an L.
Dude, that's ridiculous.
I mean, yeah, no, sorry, yeah.
Okay.
Looking
like a one in that.
That's why you
write
a line,
Anyway, hope that made sense for everybody. Yeah, is it good? Yeah.
And
if
it was a capillary, it'd be whatever. I don't think just T's
known. Number 10 is Number 10 is pretty easy.
Yeah.
We're just comparing the values, so I'll put up the values and I'll let you guys determine. I'm gonna write the left's gonna be this one. And then the right's going to be these, right? So the first one is 1.09 compared to 0.54. Second one is 0.8. Let me write a little bigger.
We're not doing the equations anymore. It's going to run.
There's actually an equation, I mean, no element with two capital letters.
No.
Yeah.
No,
it's always,
that's what I was saying. It would have been like, I don't think just T's an element, but it'd be TIA.
That makes sense.
Yeah,
that makes sense. Yeah, that does. Yeah. After some thought. Yes. The font still looks the same, though.
The font is confusing, I have to admit that.
Is
that a 7-3 or 3-3-3-3? Can't even read my own writing, geez. All right, so for number 10, we're just going to see which one is going to be the stronger oxidizing agent. So what does that mean?
It's being reduced.
Which one has to be reduced the most, right?
Yeah.
Cool. So so between bromium and iodine, bromine, right? Higher number?
Yeah.
Ag plus Cu?
Silver,
right? Okay. Chlorine and gold, is it? Yeah, gold?
Gold.
Magnesium and potassium?
Magnesium.
Peroxide, hydrogen peroxide and chromate?
Dichromate.
Bright chromate.
Excuse me.
Sorry. Dichromate. Peroxide. All right. Not too bad, right? It's kind of insulting. Think about it.
It's like what's the bigger positive?
Yeah.
Well, it's nice,
because
then you get those questions already.
Yeah, that's true. And there's, trust me, like there's quite a bit of these questions, so be prepared.
Yeah,
and make sure you know what this means. Stronger oxidizing agent means it likes to be reduced more.
Yeah.
Stronger reducing agent means it likes to be oxidized more. So make
sure
you guys know what that means.
Yeah.
That's very important.
It's so easy. It's easy to get it wrong.
Yeah,
it's so easy.
Is that straightforward?
Yeah, it's that straightforward.
Okay.
You just look at the more positive.
Yeah,
if you want, you look at the chart and compare them, but that takes a little too long.
Harder.
Yeah.
Wow.
I never knew that, so I looked at the chart.
To be honest, this is like kind of, we made it like it's so easy, but we had to grab these from the table.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And flip them, right?
Yeah. Oh, okay, yeah.
Or not flip them, but look at them, right?
Yeah.
Do you guys see
the
difference?
It's like the magnitude of the number.
Wait, what flip them?
Yeah, why
the magnitude.
Flip them? Oh,
no,
like oxidizing agent.
Yeah, but what if on the chart you don't have that one, though?
Yeah.
What I'm saying is, like, let's say we didn't have AU3 plus, but we had AU2 plus or something like that. Do you see the subtlety there? Yeah, there's a lot of. But we're not going to open the textbook and show you guys how to do all. But I do recommend spending some time doing this.
Yeah, because they're all oxidizing agents.
Make sure you can replicate this. Because it's super easy once you have the numbers.
Whoa.
But you have to get the numbers.
So the chart going from ion to solid is oxidizing or reducing? Well,
because these are all the reduction potential. So these are all.
But this is the reduction potential.
Yeah.
All of them are here are oxidized.
No, but it's not flipped. It's positive.
All of them are oxidized.
No, no. You're so on the chart, you're going to have these numbers exactly the same.
Yeah.
But Nate was just pointing out that you just had a. That you just had to.
You need to know whether to flip them.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's the issue. Yeah.
States don't matter in this case, right?
Oh, so remember, be very careful with it. I don't think states matter very much.
Not in this case.
No, but just be super careful with it. Yeah.
When you're drawing, they do. When you're drawing, they do. Yeah. But now we're doing this. Good.
Yeah. So this, just make sure when you get home, you try to do this. Again, it's super easy if you have the numbers. Yeah. Nothing easy.
It's easy while you're doing it.
Yeah, exactly. That's true. This is more conceptual, but we don't need to do this, write anything out, so we'll just talk about it. So, because obviously, like, we don't have your textbook with you, right? So, the reduction potential for this ion is negative 0.43. Now, suggest some substances that would be capable of reducing it.
Something lower than it, right?
Because then if it wants to reduce it, then we know that if something's higher than the other one, then it'll be the one that gets reduced, right? So that means we need a number less than 0.43. So an example would be like negative 0.63 or something like that. Cool? So expect a lot of stuff like this. Which ones are capable of oxidizing what and which and stuff like that. So super easy once you get the hang of it. Yeah? Potential of that. Man, it's a pain writing these half reactions. Let's see. Writing the half reaction of that. You know what? Can I have your book actually?
Which book?
She has a book. Oh. Because on ProFaz, they write the flip version.
Oh, right.
So you don't actually see the original one. It's easier if you see the original, actually. It's appendix, right?
The chart?
Yeah.
I thought it was
18.1. Or is it
18.1?
Okay. Keep saying, like, refer to appendix there.
Yeah, appendix, I think it was 6. No, after that.
I'm not sure.
Page 901.
901, thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do, do, do.
I
don't
know.
Okay. So believe it or not, it would be easier for me to do it this way than to actually read what they're saying here. So, okay, so let's just write this down. So this is zero.
Fun one.
A zero? You walked away.
You should have
asked. I had a minus one. Is that fine? Yep. Okay, so it looks like we have aluminum here. So that's being what?
Oxidized.
Oxidized, right? So that means then whatever one I see here, I'm going to grab it and I'm going to flip it. I'm going to flip it. Is that cool? So then the normal value for that, let's see, aluminum, it's near the bottom. So that's negative 2.37, so it becomes positive 2.37.
What is
the EMF? It's usually negative 2.37. So
why
I had to.
Because it's being oxidized.
Because it's being oxidized, yeah. Mm-hmm.
What is EMF?
Oh, right. Cell potential.
I think it's negative 1.66.
0.66.
I think you looked
a little bright, though. Yes, I did. Yeah, see? I still fucked up somehow.
When you're standing.
Some of them did, yeah. Negative 1.66, so it becomes positive 1.66. Iodine's being reduced, we can just grab that from the chart. So from that case, it's going to be... Do you see iodine? Yeah, there it is. 0.54.
Yes.
Great.
Oh, wow.
Cool. All right, so then the standard shell potential is that... So let's do the half reactions, because we need to figure out how many moles of electrons are transferred. So let's do that. So then the half reaction for aluminum being oxidized would look like how it is written there. 2Al plus 2Al.
Solid.
Yeah, I guess we could do it. So. that's six electrons, right?
Because
it goes from 0 to 3, but there's two of them, so it's six electrons. Cool? So we got V3I2. I'm going to write that the way it is. Solid. And I get 6I minus. And it looks like that's also, because that goes from 0 to minus 1, but there's six of them, so that's six electrons. So it's actually already balanced for us. That's kind of nice. Mm-hmm. If it wasn't, we'd have to do that ourselves, right?
Right.
We'd write each half, and we'd balance it after that, based off electrons.
Mm.
Cool. Electrons. No, yeah, so it's all nice. Okay, so we're getting the EMF. When is that? So then, because we have different concentrations, we're going to have to use the Nernst equation. Remember that one? Yeah? So that one's what? The
E cell
equals E cell standard, right?
Yeah.
Is it minus 0.592
mm-hmm.
over N times the log of Q? Is that right?
Yeah.
So once we have that, we just got to plug and chug. We do have a Q in this case, so that means it's going to be products over reactants. But the Q does not contain the solids. Right? If there was an aqueous, if these were aqueous, we would include them in the Q. But because these are solids, we don't include them. So that in Q.
So in this case, for this class, we wouldn't have to, because it showed us how we derived the 0.592, we don't have to actually go into the...
No, yes, that's a good point. Because the actual Nernst equation's like, I think it's like RT something times, the 2.303.
No, he said we didn't have to derive all that.
He's gonna be nice, because I think he's gonna be doing all at 25 degrees Celsius, which means that it's always gonna be this.
All at 25.
Yeah, because it's 298 times that, so.
Yeah.
Or if the standard would be K, then Q?
Yeah, if it's, if it's a...
equilibrium.
Yeah, equilibrium, it's K. Yeah.
And I think it's like just a...
It's just the same thing.
It's a positive version of itself.
Yeah, it's 0.0592 over N log K.
Log K and stuff. Okay, so then... so let's do this really fast. The Q in this case, again, remember, you needed to balance this, right? Because in the concentration for Q, they become powers.
Right.
So for aluminum, it's 4.0 times 10 to the negative 3, but we square it, right? Do you see that? And then 0.010 to the sixth power. So do you see how much that affects that, right?
Yeah.
So balancing your equation is pivotal. Cool. So then we can plug that Q into there. And what's going to be my N in this case?
In the six?
Yeah, it'd be six electrons, right? So my N's equal to six. Great, and I think we have everything, the E cell, that's what we haven't calculated yet. Or did it give it to us? Yeah, even nice. Nice. If it didn't do that, we could do that ourselves, right?
Right.
Yeah.
We just use the cell potentials and balance it. So N is the, N stands for moles of electrons. So you know how when we add the electrons in the half reactions?
Uh-huh.
That's gonna be the moles. So remember you balance those, right?
Uh-huh.
The balanced number of electrons is your N. Cool?
Oh, okay, good.
So that's gonna be what you plug in there. So if you don't do that step, you're going to get it wrong. I guess you wouldn't know what to put there, so you'd probably get it wrong. Yeah, you'd be like, so we're just going to plug in the values. That's going to be E cell equals 2.20 volts minus 0.0592 over 6 times the log of
Q.
This guy here. I'm going to put Q. I'm lazy. Yeah. So what do you get?
You get a... 2.37.
Great.
E cell.
Awesome. And that actually is consistent with Le Chatelier's principle as well, is it not? Because we lowered the concentration of the aluminum ion, right? Which is going to be on the right side, so when we lower it, it shifts it this way, right?
Yep.
That make sense? Normally you have like, if you have a, this is actually important too, I haven't seen any of these yet on the questions, but how you affect the concentrations of the products and reactants will affect your E cell, right? So then, if we have a high concentration of the aluminum, from a high concentration of aluminum ion, it would lower this because it would propel it this way. Cool. So just be aware that your answer should also make sense. Our value is bigger because it's pulling it this way. Cool. We're good. Yep.
Cool.
Do you need this or
do you
want to
have the equation?
You wrote them down? Nice.
Well, actually, No, yeah, I'm gonna need that.
Well, you have a long one.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's not too bad, though. Just gotta make sure that.
To write them down.
At equilibrium, delta. I mean, E cell is zero, so.
Yeah, that's nice. How do you guys feel about this chapter?
It's not too bad, right?
It's not too bad.
It's really not bad, right? But there's like a ton of little, like little tiny steps, right? Oh, don't forget to do this. Don't forget to do that.
2.36 was the answer?
It was 2.37.
2.37. Not by. Okay. So the next one is 13. Use a standard reduction potential listed in your textbook. Oops, you guys can't see that.
Use your textbook.
My textbook, right? Okay. So you just set a risk potential with the textbook to determine the equilibrium constant for each following reaction. Okay.
Right big.
In this problem, we're going to use the Nernst equation.
Yeah.
Right? So, but it's at equilibrium, so let's write it down. The delta, I mean, not delta. E cell.
Yeah. Thinking of Gibbs or what?
Yeah. E cell. At non-standard conditions is equal to E of the cell standard conditions.
How do you know to use that equation?
It's asking for at equilibrium.
It's asking for the
and K as well. Equilibrium constant too. So the only one that has the equilibrium constant is the this one right here, which is minus what is it?
0.592.
Over n.
Log of k. Yeah, I missed the zero, huh? This is zero before the five, my bad.
But it's not at standard.
Like, how do you know it's not at standard, though? Because there's another equation that you can use to find k at standard states. And it doesn't really tell you it's not at standard.
We're at equilibrium, though, right?
Yeah, so he's just showing you something really quick. He's going to derive it right now. Yeah. So
delta E is zero at equilibrium, right?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, not delta. Delta E. E cell at non-standard conditions is zero. So we could replace this with the zero, and we're left with E cell minus 0.059 over
n. Equals log of k.
You gave us that equation at standard state, so that's why I guess I'm sort of confused. Mm.
So take a look.
Wait, what's your question? I'm not sure what your question's saying, yeah.
Yesterday,
he gave us the equation down there. So E cell at standard states equals 0.0592 over n times log of k.
Yeah.
But he gave us that at standard states.
Yeah.
But in this case, we're at equilibrium, right?
Yeah, that's fine, though. Yeah, that's the same equation.
Remember he said when it's not at standard states, what's fluctuating is the temperature?
Yeah, so no, Moises is going to use the right equation, because what happens is he's going to move that over to the other side. If then you get the same equation.
Okay. Right. But first we gotta calculate delta E cell, which is E cell, sorry.
Yeah.
Using our reduction potentials.
Yeah, you can actually pretty much only know the one with the other E cell at non-standard.
Yeah.
And if you're at standard, it becomes zero and you get the regular Nernst equation again. So it kind of gives you have one equation to know, right? Instead of two and being like, oh, when do I use this? You can just make it zero, and then subtract it over to the other side.
Does equilibrium mean standard? Are they equal?
Or, right?
So how do you know to use the standard, solve for the standard E cell?
If it tells you at 25 degrees?
I think it said standard in this case, so we need to use it, I guess.
Oh, standard.
It says standard, right? Yeah. Yeah. So that's how you know to do it, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we have SN.
It's like once you know what to do, it's like super easy. But it's like getting to like the setup problem is the weird part. Yeah, so it's not like KSP. KSP.
So when you write the half reaction, it's better to go by what they do on this chart and write it in that way rather than write it the way you think it looks.
Well, if you do it this way, you can see it pretty clearly what's going on, but it's really up to you. So because we're writing it on the board, it makes more sense for us to do it this way and then flip it so you guys can see it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
the longer way.
In your way, but if I were in your shoes, I would just see it and flip it as necessary. Yeah.
Cool. So we have our reduction potentials here, right?
So this one is gonna, we clearly see that zinc gets oxidized, but so we're gonna flip this one, right? So I'm gonna keep it the same, but I'm gonna flip that one, so you guys take it.
Go to zinc solid. Goes to E minus plus zinc 2 plus, right?
Everything here is balanced, right? So you just cross. So 2E and 2E gonna cancel. I'm gonna left with this over right quick, so it's gonna be
SN 2 plus plus zinc solid goes to zinc 2 plus plus.
Now since we did that, we're gonna flip this one because this is being oxidized.
By the way, the next like three questions are this.
That's
like, and that's it. And that's the end of the review.
Yeah. So now that we have
so you're pretty much done with the.
So now we have this, we can plug it back into here and just do a little algebra and solve for log of k, right? So E cell is equal to
0.0.
And n is 2, right? 2 electrons are transferred to 2.
Right.
And then log of k. That. And we do that. We can subtract this. It's a negative as well, right?
This is number 13, right? Yeah. So your K, 8.9 times 10 to the 20.
8.9 times 10 to the 20. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I just took the antilog because the antilog of K, log is 10 to the, so. Take the antilog, solve for K. Because you're solving for the equilibrium constant.
Yeah.
So that's,
the nurse.
The products, what is it called?
No, not.
Favor and the products?
K is bigger.
That'd be favoring the products, yeah,
mm-hmm.
Right? Because it's products over reactants.
Right. Oh, you're right, yeah.
Right? Yeah. So if you have a big number, that means the ratio of your products over reactants is very big. So. Yeah. And that makes sense, too. So your K value, so there's three relationships, right?
Mm-hmm.
K should be greater than 1.
Right.
G should be negative.
Wait.
And E cell should be positive.
It's 8.9, right?
8.9, yeah. Sorry, have sloppy writing.
No, probably.
Is that good? Yeah.
Super polite. It was probably the marker, not you, Moises.
I write like I have the penmanship of like first grade or something.
That's
cool.
All
right. Part B is the same thing. Do you guys want me to run through that as well?
No, right now.
Okay, cool. So next one.
They're all like this now. So.
Yeah.
I was gonna go through some. We can do the multiple choice for this.
Cool.
Yeah.
This chapter's not too bad, right?
No.
A lot better.
It's probably like the hardest so far.
It's downright easy.
Yeah.
It's downright easy.
Yeah, I need to review about
half of it. Oh, on the CSUN test.
Yeah.
I haven't done those before. Ooh, cool.
Actually, I haven't done them either. I didn't do it for that test.
Yeah, me neither.
Pull up the solution. Homegirl strikes again. She's Jackson.
She gave all the answers on that key except for the very, very last question.
Nice. Good. Oh, have you already done it already?
Yeah, I did. Well, I didn't do the like the short answer stuff, but I did all the multiple.
Wait, nice. First CSUN. It's like CSUN. If you want it, Nate could email it to you.
Nathan, anybody ask you about the lab question?
Oh, that stupid lab question.
The one that
could join
you?
Yeah.
Oh, I heard
about
it.
Yeah.
Did you hear about it?
I heard about it.
We all
failed.
What
worst.
Did she do? I'm curious.
She gave her a bounce back.
She
gave her a bounce back.
She gave you a bounce back.
Wait, so what did you do afterwards?
14 out of 8.
Like, not even to do it. Like,
was that a bounce back?
That's because we weren't there. That's why. No, I'm joking.
Well, even.
We'll try it later if we have to.
Was it?
Do you guys take a picture of it or no?
Yeah, I remember.
They had
you remember?
Yeah.
We didn't have enough.
No, it was basically
it.
Like
yeah.
What? We have the KSP and it's in a 0.1 molar solution of KI. So it's like the KSP equals
and
S times 0.1 plus 2S squared and find out what S is.
But you can't solve for S.
You like
can't solve
for
S squared
like
S.
You can't
oh, you have to use the Laplace transform. And
yeah, just got to
like
factor a third degree polynomial.
You can't do
just P over Q. Do it. Come on.
You gotta, do, you gotta do the inverse Laplace and then
no.
That's
Laplace.
Super easy. Super easy.
No.
Just execute the Laplace transform.
You just made a word up.
No, no, it's a math. It's a math thing. Just
taking consideration that differentials are going to.
All right, time for some lighthearted stuff, right? Yeah.
Would you be able to send it to me?
Yo, yeah.
Can I like break down my emails?
I have it right here. Give me a second. You just type forward. Where are you? Yeah, send it to me also, maybe.
It's not nice.
Go.
Especially with
the
questions. Yeah, but she did say like, oh, one of the questions is kind of like your lab, but it's not from your lab. Because
I would have been asked. I would
reference.
Have been asked her about that. I was like, it was a concentration session.
Awesome.
Yeah. Thanks a lot for nothing.
So you guys did
you,
get
it.
It
was a short
so we did get a lecture
we
example.
Yeah, I want to tell
school. She's still got it. She's like, oh, you guys didn't get an actual exam?
Gotcha.
Let me do that for you. She like rubs her hands and listens.
I just
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
I
looked at it. I was like,
oh,
sure.
Oh, did she send the email? Come on, man.
I
was kind of hoping she would just.
Is this really all you want to do? Is this a trick question?
Yeah. Oh,
you're
trying to make up
you're there, bro.
Yeah.
It'll be the last like two
arm.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
no.
Then
no.
Everything's gonna be here. The whole chapter.
No.
And 17 is here.
You're gonna have so much fun.
So,
like,
so
I send everything.
So the last four are the ones.
But the requirement
yep.
For that class is like algebra.
We're in this class, right?
Yeah. He's got a factor of the third degree polynomial.
I thought that was for easy for me then.
Oh, because of his shirt and his slacks.
I'll turn into a regrouping and I'll turn into
a bunch of
New age method.
But she said calculate. She just said like which one's greater or something. Oh, no problem. She said calculate. She wants a number.
Well, sucks to suck.
I'm glad she got you guys. That's what I'm doing.
Yeah. You guys didn't have a lecture exam, so.
Yeah, I need to know.
Okay.
I mean, I guess.
She
teaches
51
of this summer.
Oh, yeah.
Or email her before I get there.
Want to do this?
Yep. Alright, guys.
We're going to get started. Yeah, this is much easier, though, so it might help with the conceptual stuff, at least, maybe. Alright, so identify oxidation. So is oxidation an increase in the oxidation number?
No, loss of electrons.
Well, let's think. So it was Mn to Mn 2 plus, right? It would be a 2 plus and a 0. So
loss of
electrons. Yeah, that actually kind of works then, right? Yeah? Okay.
Yeah.
Identify a loss of electron. No, it's a... Well, that is right.
Yeah.
Losing, right?
Loss of electrons.
So it's E.
So it's going to be...
Wait, increase in oxidation. Yes.
So from here to here, it's increased, right?
Oh,
sneaky. Cool?
Yeah.
Okay.
I never thought it like
this. Oh, yeah, sure.
Write the element being oxidized and flowing down.
Why can't the exam be like this?
Wait, hey, H2O2 is one of those exceptions, huh?
This one's good, actually.
Yeah.
So,
I'm going to Susan.
If you guys remember, H2O2 is one of those exceptions to the oxidation rules, right?
What is there? Is it on the chart?
Yeah, peroxides, oxygen has a different oxidation number.
Correct.
All
right.
Because you start with
that one's
hydrogen.
Yeah. So,
yeah.
Hydrogen is going to be a plus 1 here.
Okay.
2 plus overall.
Oh,
so this oxygen has to be what then?
-1.
Okay.
-1.
So overall -1, but it's 2 minus charge, right?
Oh, the hierarchy is the H on the top?
Yeah, because it goes to the first
two
columns.
Yeah, H2O2 is one of those weird exceptions.
Table.
Yeah.
And then you're...
Okay, so next.
On the test?
Huh?
Final
I don't know, it's for you to find out. Not kidding, no, it's not. So oxygen, 2 minus, right, overall, 2 minus total, 4 minus overall. So this chlorine has to be 4 plus, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Cool?
Yeah.
Same thing here, 2 minus for oxygen, 4 minus overall, but there's a minus charge overall, so this chlorine has to be 3 plus.
Yeah.
is O2 is 0. So we see that oxygen got oxidized.
Yeah.
And chlorine got reduced. So it's asking for what element is being oxidized. So it's going to be oxygen. So B.
Gotcha.
Yeah? This is like the good part of this question, that you got to know that H2O2 in this case always on minus one charge. That's one of the only exceptions.
What? Say again?
The oxygen's attached to the chlorines, but they don't change. Their oxidation numbers don't change, so I don't think it matters.
Yeah, it's two minus.
Yes,
they change from.
He writes his oxy numbers on the bottom.
Yeah, on the bottom. I pointed that out. I was like, this is the charge per one, it's overall charge. That's how I do it.
Well, I think what she's asking is on the first, that first part, you have oxygen that's negative one, and then it changes to zero on the other side. But the middle bits that are attached to the chlorine don't change, so you just ignore them.
Right.
If it doesn't change.
It changes overall still. It stays from two, even if this changes from two, it goes from two. That's weird, yeah.
Because two minus to two minus and one
yeah,
minus.
Yeah, I see what you
they're
mean.
They're both oxygen.
I mean, in this case, it's oxygen is clearly the one who gets oxidized.
Yeah,
here.
Nothing else is oxidized.
Yeah. So you just have to do process of elimination, I guess. Just know that oxygen is only getting reduced here, and the rest are all staying the same, so you know that oxygen got oxidized. Yeah.
I really like that option D is nitrogen. There's an nitrogen there.
Damn.
Oh, obviously.
Oh wow.
It's like someone. Let's.
It's like one of those like nitrogen. Those like dumb answers.
Oh my god. Like it's all but.
Imagine I read that wrong.
I think she does that so then you can't. If you guess, you have a less likely chance of getting the answer right. Right?
Oh, balance of. Oh,
shit. Oh, yeah. Okay. I thought you were going to say greater chance. I was like,
less.
Well, obviously it's not.
No, you know what I mean, though? Like, so if you're just like kind of going and guessing, you have a way
just
less
like,
chance of getting it right. Yeah.
Alright, so
you
just
got to
balance this thing.
Or teacher. Put six
she's
options.
She's really going to make you balance this in
a multiple
choice.
You're not going to get it right. I'm going to put six options.
Alright, let's do it then. So, is oxygen's two minus? We're not going this one, Nate? Are you good?
Two minus.
Two minus. Eight
seriously?
Minus overall. Seven plus charge, right? So that's going to be a minus.
Mm.
Right.
Yeah. Two minus.
Wait, doesn't hydrogen go first?
Oh, plus one, good, thank you. Two
so
plus overall.
Hydrogen always goes first. Yeah,
yes.
I think the first
okay.
two columns goes first.
Then we consider that as two minus, yeah.
That's
going to be something else.
Eight minus, so that has to be
I
six
can't
plus.
Those
group one and two.
Right, three plus
they're
each.
Like
right? Each carbon's three
I
plus.
I know what you mean.
There's two, so it's a six plus overall.
Yeah.
So that's going to balance. Zero, net charge. Yeah.
Which
cool.
column?
Huh?
The first two.
Oh,
sorry.
Oh, right. Magnesium is 2 plus here. Oxygen
yeah.
is 2 minus. 4 minus overall. 4 plus.
I can't
okay.
believe she just on a multiple choice question.
So carbon
oh my god. Jesus
got
Christ.
Oxidized. No, yeah, it's got oxidized.
I guess they're all multiple choice, aren't they? Yeah.
And then what got reduced here? The magnesium got reduced.
Not for the most part,
yeah. Okay?
Yeah?
So, there are half reactions and balance out everything. Okay. So, let's write half reactions.
Jesus Christ,
so, MnO4 plus, how many electrons did you get reduced by?
Five.
Five. So, plus five. Yes. Goes to Mn2 plus. Yes?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. So now, this part, the oxidation part. This is
changed by two.
I don't know what kind of acid this is, but it's some acid.
Wait,
H2C2O4, ascorbic acid maybe? I don't know. Goes to how many electrons we said? One. Minus CO2.
What about C2O4 again? What is that?
It's ascorbic acid, is it? I don't know.
It might be, yeah.
Yeah. Alright, and that's CO2, good. Yeah? This is our half reduction. Oh. There you go.
And it's an acidic solution.
Yes. So we gotta balance out the
oxalic acid?
Oxalate, yeah, that's what it is. C2O4 is the oxalate.
So now we gotta balance out the oxygens and hydrogens, right? Because if we leave right here, we're not completely balanced. So let's balance the first one. So I have four O's here, so I have to add four waters on this side, right, to balance?
Excellent.
Yeah?
Cool.
Now I have zero H's here, but I have eight here, so I'm going to add eight H pluses. Yeah?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Have four H, four O's here, and two here, so I'm going to add two waters.
Yeah. And then you need to add
that. Two H pluses on that side, right? Yes. Now. Yeah?
Yeah?
So now we just have to balance the electrons out.
Yeah.
Wow, this is a long question.
It's asking for the coefficients in front.
So it'll be a 5, most likely. So I think if we stop here, so the coefficient in front of the H2, yeah, it'd be a 5.
Yeah.
So we could just stop. I mean, unless you guys want me to do the rest of it, unless you guys are feeling a little iffy.
Good question.
Yeah.
So then there's one C on the carbon dioxide, and then there's 2 in the oxalic acid.
Oh, that's a good point.
What was
that?
That trick again?
So I think
what
that's
that?
Why I ended up with 2 electrons.
No, you're...
What happened?
I wasn't paying
oh,
attention. What happened?
Carbon.
You're right.
Oh, yeah, that's 2.
Ah.
Yeah, well, I didn't balance
no.
4.
No, that has to go back because it changed.
Yeah.
No, I did this problem like 5 times. I did race to
No, good. That's a good catch.
So then
I didn't balance before.
That becomes 2
oh,
electrons.
Yeah, so that's going to be 2 here.
And that means you times... that by 5 and the other one by 2.
Yeah.
Which will give
ridiculous numbers.
Is that what she is? But they're all.
But that's not an answer.
Yeah, they're not an answer, so I'm guessing.
But the water is not there.
I'm guessing
oh, yeah.
She.
Yeah, her answer is wrong.
Oh, her answer is wrong? Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
It says, like, oh, check. Oh, like.
Yeah.
But we know what you're supposed to.
Yeah. But yeah, I didn't balance that C before I went on. So that's a good point. And that's going to change all these numbers as well.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to have more oxygen more oxygen here. So yeah, that's a good point.
Okay.
So yeah, I always forget that step. Balance, make sure everything's balanced before you move on. Except for the O's and H's, of course. So, I mean, I guess there's no right answer in this case, you said? If we do it.
Yeah, even if
she
doesn't
even
know
the answer.
Even if you do it the way you did it, you
oh,
have
good old
yeah,
which isn't an
option. Yeah, you'd have a lot of a different number. I see. Yeah,
right.
I know what you mean. Because in the end, we're gonna be multiplying by it. By yeah. Okay.
I need to keep
get
going because we don't have the answer. So
you
yeah, can you solve
this? No. The heck? You can do yourself. No. Okay, yeah, of course. So now I have to erase all this then, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Aye.
I mean, you don't have to erase all of it.
Too late.
No, he needs to.
Need to.
Needs
okay.
To.
So now, yeah, that's right, you didn't have to, huh? Shit. Shoot. Yeah, man. Oh, 4. This is the oxidation part, yes. Plus.
Change the charge on
the let's see.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's so good. Oh my god.
It's not.
This is such a good problem.
This one?
No, the one I'm going to show you next.
It'll change it to the electron.
Yes.
But it won't actually
so
change. That'll still be plus.
Oh,
that carbon
no, it's down here.
It's like.
Oh, I know. I see it's gone. Oh, I see. Okay. Let's try that
again. Oh, still the same. It's 2 plus, right? There's 2. Let's do the same. We're good.
Yeah.
Just keep it
going.
No.
Okay.
It's
still 1 electron though, right?
Yeah.
This is a 2, so
it?
Yeah, we're still good. It's still 1 electron, so this answer would be right then. Because there's a 2 here, there's a 2 here, and there's a 2 here as well. So there's only 1 electron that went over, right?
Yeah.
So in this case, we had it right then.
Yeah, but you had 6 H2Os. Because you had a 4 and a 2.
But what I mean here, there's still 1 electron, right? Because this. The 2 here and the 2 here, so that's it went by 1 electron. 3 plus, 2 plus. Right?
I was picked in.
Delta.
Huh?
It doesn't matter. It's two in
front. No, I'm doing another problem in my head. It's hard.
It's a
the mashing problem.
There's also a 2.
Did you do that one?
But don't you need another electron? Because that carbon needs to balance. So isn't it, you don't you need 2 electrons to balance out 2 CO2s?
Oh, yeah.
There.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, you need 2 electrons.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a whole different moment.
Okay. So now we balance out the water. So here's gonna be 4H plus, 4H2O, sorry.
Man, the next one is so good.
I forgot that 2 again here, huh? Yeah, I did. Seems the same thing.
Treat. Is this one hard?
No, it's just
this one
it's
right
just
now.
Cause
yeah,
it's hard.
Did it twice.
Four
or if,
can be
it's
six.
Weird.
If you don't balance it, it's hard. Yeah.
But balance.
Well, that's the first thing it tells you. Balance the following reaction.
Well, yeah, we'll get our end result and see if it's balanced correctly at the end.
Yeah,
6H plus, 4 there, 6 you're good. Yeah, multiply it by 5, multiply it by 2.
Right into the middle of that one would be A.
So 5 and 2.
No, never mind.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
So let's read this. 16H pluses.
I forgot how to do these water things.
Because when you times the entire thing by 5,
I see, yeah. It would be what?
It's
going
to be
yeesh,
like
big number?
Crazy.
Big number for water?
Yeah.
Huh.
Well, we'll see if it balances out the end.
Yeah,
not when we
at the end, you can like, make it smaller if it's all even numbers.
No, what I mean.
All hydrogens are on those sides.
You write everything by 2?
Yeah.
Or, sorry, all the waters are on one side, so they don't cancel out. They just get a
yeesh.
What was the thing again? The per every electron is 1 to water.
I'll show you right now.
I would review this one.
You're wrong.
Wait, okay, those are.
Yeah.
So that's 30H plus, not 33 OHs, right?
Yeah.
I was like, what?
Yeah,
where'd you get the OHs from?
Yeah, that's confused. So it seems like nothing cancels, right? So we're just
adding
the electrons. There's going to be 46H pluses on this side.
Oh,
my God.
I think we're out 30s when we gave up.
Well, the answer was 5 to 1.
So,
yeah,
it's
like
never in there.
Dr. Kaiser, man, what the heck?
Yeah, it's the multiple choice. The third one, too.
How many questions
are there?
Yeah,
questions
are
there.
Like 50, I think.
There's a lot.
How much time do they get?
Probably not enough.
Can you imagine taking this test and this is number 3?
She put a redox that doesn't have an answer on it like, for number 3. Are you fucking kidding?
So, yeah, that's just 28 times 2 is 46. We have 46 over there. Oh, but then we have these 10. So, it doesn't. So, we did something wrong.
Wait, what? What do you mean we did something?
Because there's
but you forgot the MnO4 as a minus. Yeah. MnO4 is a minus. Yeah.
Yeah.
No. But we're balanced, right? This would be the iron result. Now let's just see if the hydrogens at balance. So 28 times 2 is 48.
Yeah.
46. 46 here, but there's a 10 here, so we did something wrong. So I don't know.
Did you look at her answer?
Yeah, because if we do it this way, what if we keep that as a 1, see if that works out on that side? Maybe, let's try it. Keep that as a 1.
Is this really that hard, right?
Yeah, it's because, like,
what the fuck is it?
So I'm going to have 30.
She didn't really solve it. I guess so.
Huh?
What happens if you add the water in the original equation?
So look, this is all going to be the same, except that's not going to be multiplied. So that's going to stay the same. That's going to stay the same. That's going to stay the same.
4.
So let's see. We have 38.
Say again? Oh, are you trying it for a bunch? Oh, I'll try it after. On paper.
It's
going to
be
12,
48. Does it work that way?
I don't think the charges will ever really cancel out.
Because even if we add these waters on this side, once you add them, we get 38. 10 is 48.
Because you have so many oxygens, all of your A pluses are on the left side, and they just keep building up. There's nothing on the right side to cancel it.
Yeah, you see? Even if we keep that as a 1. Yeah, I know. Yeah. Even if you see that as a 1.
What happens?
Should we just move on?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We know how to.
Yeah, you guys know how to balance it. So that's the good thing. Yeah, this is. I mean, she even didn't provide an answer. So there must be something wrong with this. Is it that or I'm done?
That's
probably both. But.
Is one a hard one? Yeah. Not hard, but it's fine. It's good.
All right, go for it.
But you should learn it.
Not the. Oh, I'll teach you.
This is super good.
No.
This one's super good.
Yeah. Because you just do it, whether it's
basic or acidic, you use the acidic method.
I was like,
and then looking at, and I was looking at her answer sheet, and I'm just like, how do you go from here to here?
Oh, did she actually solve this or no?
She did.
Oh, I couldn't find it, so I was going to do it.
It was weird.
You ready? All right, yeah. This one's super good. Let's see if I can do it one try.
Oh, yeah, dude, I showed it to you.
Okay,
yeah.
So with this one, we're doing a matching problem. This is good. Check it out.
Oh,
that's
a good
one. So, we need to match the E cells to these. So because we're doing E cell and delta G and Qs, I'm going to write out all the equations. Because that'd be useful, right? Then we can use them as for comparison. So E cell, notice that's without the node, right? It's E cell. That's equal to E node, right? So minus
0.52. Zero.
Log of Q, right?
Or K.
Q. And then this one, that one is negative, positive, 0.0582. Yeah.
Why was Q equals K? Why was Q equals K?
Say, I don't know.
Why can Q and K be replaced?
Why can they be replaced? This is at this E cell without the node means non-standard molarities. Yeah. So because it's a different molarity, we have to have a Q, right?
Gotcha.
Yeah. Cool. What else we got? Delta G, right? That'd be delta G is equal to negative NFE.
E node.
I can already see the problem with this. This is hard. Okay. Yeah. I think that's everything we need. Yeah. Ready?
No.
Okay. So we're going to match all of these. So I think there's probably going to be multiple matches.
Yeah.
And what we're going to do is we're going to then, the ones that are limited, we're going to be able to erase and so on. So, okay. So when E cell is less than zero, okay. So that's E cell standard, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that'd be this one, and we get a negative number. So that would mean that this would have to be bigger than this for that to happen.
Right.
Is that cool? Yeah, so then, all right, so then what does that mean?
It means Q needs to be really, really small.
And needs to be really small?
Because
then you get a positive number, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so then what else is there? All right.
So Q needs to be less than K?
Maybe it might be useful to write this equation in terms of E, you know what I mean? So we can solve for E cell, right? Or this one, maybe, so this would have to be negative, right? This would have to be less than 1.
Yeah.
Because if you get a log of a number less than 1, it becomes negative, and it'd be a positive added with a positive, and your E cell would be bigger.
Yeah.
See that? So that means that this one, when E cell is less than 0, so let's see.
So then it's not.
Oh, we want it when it's less than.
No, because you want it to be.
Yeah, you want it to be positive.
You want the log of Q.
So this one is when Q is less than 1.
So you have a large negative that consumes your E standard cell, which will then make.
But then negative times the negative is positive.
No, but if you take the log of a very small number, it'll give you a positive.
Yeah.
Negative, right? Or log, yeah. Here we go.
Yeah, it'll give you a positive. Number.
Right.
And that's what you want.
Yeah.
So you want Q to be really
small. So you want the log of a very small
number. To make it that, yeah.
To get a big number.
Yeah.
To consume.
Yeah.
The
but in relation to K though, what is the relation for it to K though? That's the weird part.
Less than?
It'd have to be less than, right?
Wait, no, if you had a log of a small number, less than 1, you get negative.
Yeah. Negative, which is what we want because of this.
Yeah.
Negative,
yeah.
Negative,
you
positive.
Get a negative number.
There it goes.
Yeah.
It needs to be less than 1.
Yeah, it has to be, if it's greater than 1, you get a positive. It's less.
Yeah. No, you're right.
You get a negative number. That's why I was like, wait.
Huh?
No, you're right.
Have I been lied to my entire life?
Which one do you get? 6? Yes. Right. So when's that one?
Yeah.
6 is E, right? Yeah? Yeah. So that one. Great. Another one. We have another one too. This one's kind of cool. So what's the log of 1?
0.
0, right?
Zero.
So when Q is equal to 1,
you get E cell equals E.
You get E cell equals E regular cell.
Yeah.
So Q is equal to 1. We have a relation there. Boom. Nice. I kind of kind of like this though, because it's making you like think about the different scenarios you can have, right?
When Q was, sorry,
say
that again. Log of
log of one is zero.
Log of one is zero.
So that make this zero, and then it would be E cell is equal to E nothing. Nice, cool. What else? Let's start using the delta G, right? So delta G is going to be positive when this is what? When E cell is negative, right?
Yeah.
So when E cell is less than zero, delta G will be greater than zero, right?
Yeah.
A will be greater than Q is greater than K.
I missed my trajectory. I was like, shit. It didn't occur to me I could curve, but yeah. Okay, so then the opposite is true then, right? Delta G will be negative when this, be positive, right? No, did we do positive? Yeah, less than zero when it's greater than zero.
Yeah, when E cell is less than zero, you get delta G is positive.
Right there, right? Yeah. Delta G is greater than zero when E cell is less than zero.
So it's negative.
So 5 and A?
Yeah. So then this one's going to be the opposite, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This one goes to here.
A should be number 2.
Yes, yes,
right?
Yes.
Delta G is less than zero.
Yeah, so it's negative.
When E cell is greater than 1, because that means you have a positive times a negative in that.
Yeah.
Yeah, sweet. This is fun, right? Yeah.
Is there a sign-in sheet for this workshop?
Are we done?
No.
So then by process of elimination, wouldn't that mean... A goes to that one, right?
Should I make one?
No, I'll get one.
You see that?
Nice.
So we did by process of elimination. Done.
No, but it made sense as well that number A was 2.
Can we just
because it needed
that
to be greater than?
Just as a quick.
Is that
okay? So wait, for
the log of any greater number, like large number.
I think you mixed up the E cell and E standard cell in those last two. Because D and F are not both standard and non-standard. One's standard, one's not standard. And you're both going to the delta G standards. So A, B, and D and F, I think, are kind of mixed up.
A, B, and D and F?
Yeah.
Oh, because I wasn't paying attention to the...
Yeah.
I see what you're saying. Okay. Damn. Of course. Yeah. Okay. So then, where is that? Yeah, we'll just erase everything. No. We'll start over. Yeah.
Wait, what happened?
I was being kind of careless with the notes. Yeah. I was like, oh yeah, custom. Yeah. Okay. Let's do the easy ones. So when it's equal to 1, right?
You get E cells.
E cells equal to this one, right?
Yeah.
That one's the easy one.
Oh, I see what you mean with the notes. Yeah. Okay.
See, I fucked up with the notes.
So then let's do E.
Wait. So that's delta G note. Is that delta G in your equation?
What do you mean? Which
your
one?
Formula right there.
Node. Node and
G
regular.
No, the delta G, is that node or is that?
Delta G is node.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
Node.
In front of it.
Oh,
yeah,
sorry.
Make sure.
Oh, wait, what you're saying.
Yeah, so then you won't get mixed up here.
That's not an option, though, is it?
Just in case.
It's not an option, though.
Yeah.
Okay, what's the next one that's easy?
When delta E node of the cell is greater than zero, then delta G node is less than zero?
So when, that one's good, too, but... Here's another one as well. When E cell is equal to zero, that's when Q is equal to, when
Q equals K.
Right?
Yeah.
That's a good one, right?
Oh, yeah.
When E cell is equal to zero is when Q is equal to K. Which would be here to here, right?
Now you're talking about E standard of the cell. So say you're talking about F.
So, yeah.
Less than zero.
So, do you want to do F now?
Yeah, so that means G should be greater than zero.
Yeah, so E cell, when it's less than zero, what does it do to that?
It makes
G positive, right?
Which makes it greater than zero.
So then G positive, so that would be this one then.
Yeah.
So it'd be five to that one.
So then going to the other standard, which would be B, then it'd be B and 4.
So then G, when it's less than zero, it makes it here to
B.
Here.
Okay, yeah.
Now I'm drawing the arrows in the right one. I was drawing it on the wrong note before. Okay, we're doing good.
A is 2.
So A?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, these are the weird ones, right?
Yeah.
So when E cell is less than 0, what does that do to the Q, right?
Yeah, so Q needs to be greater.
Because all we have is 2 and 3 left, right?
Yeah.
Right.
So now we can say, how does E cell affect Q?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then when E cell is greater, when here? We're talking about the non-standard. How does this affect Q? So what we can do is actually, we can imagine what, like replacing Q here, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Here's what we can do. what we can do. So we can do, let's replace, this is E cell, so let's replace that in that equation there.
Okay.
Right? And then we can get actually a direct relation between Q and K. That works, yeah. Because this is E cell here, right? Node. So let's replace, let's substitute that into that equation. Yep. So that'd be 0.0592. And,
well, so you just
so
K minus
notice
K.
That they both have this, so we can factor out the 0.0592.
And you can factor out the logs.
And you get log of K.
Minus Q.
Minus log of Q.
Yeah.
Woo, that's nice. And that's gonna be equal to delta, or no, E cell, right?
Yeah.
E cell non-standard. So we got some factoring in, some practice. Now, okay, so when the K is greater than Q, right? That
mm-hmm.
means we'd have a positive E cell,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So when K is greater than Q, so another way of saying that is when Q is less than K,
yeah,
but we have a positive E cell, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that'd be here to that.
And then A into Q.
And then it'd go A to 2. Nice. That was a good exercise, right? That was pretty good. I never realized we could totally, so this is a good equation.
Yeah.
Put that in your cheat sheet, right? What if he gives you K's and Q's, right? If you're given K and Q and N, you can solve for E cell, that's pretty good. Dope.
Dope.
That one was fun, right?
Yeah. A la Madrid.
Nope. You find it tomorrow?
Yeah.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. I'm not studying tomorrow, shit.
Why not?
No.
Liverpool, sorry, Liverpool.
11.
Oh. Can you
go in? We have to look at that one's too easy. Huh? What's the one where there's some that are good, right?
The ion ones?
Yeah, identify the reducing agent and stuff like that, right?
I think that was an art test. Not here, maybe. Light acid storage battery.
Why is the exam on Tuesday?
You guys have plenty of time.
I thought the exam was on the Tuesday after next.
No, it's only for the Monday classes because of Memorial Day.
I was not studying this whole time because I'm like, well, I have a whole week.
On the 5th, I was like, I have a whole week.
Oh wait, so you guys have so it's not Monday, it's the following Monday?
No, Tuesday.
For Monday class.
Is this I was thinking it was
so when's your final? Tuesday?
Tuesday.
Yeah. Oh. I was thinking it was the following Tuesday.
No, I'm not going to school that day. There's no school.
It is.
We're done.
But
or
I haven't been studying
Monday,
because of
Wednesday
that.
Classes whose times are later than 12. Then
no,
they're moved
Monday.
Over because on finals
but
week the Monday's
Monday
Memorial Day.
Right. So I mean the next not this
Monday,
not this Monday. But sorry, not this Tuesday, but next Tuesday. No,
this thing is
only
two chapters.
Yeah,
I'm
gonna be. Shoot, I'm gonna be
out of here.
Yeah. Nate knows what I'm gonna do after that.
Dang, ridiculous, bro.
Okay.
So, you're gonna get something like this as well.
You getting married?
Yeah.
Me at 20 years old? Yeah.
I hope you never see anything.
That's when you get divorced, is when you get married.
Oh, you guys are done with, wait, how many of you guys are done with chemistry?
Damn, sad.
Nice.
Yeah.
You guys
are
nice.
Not
taking OCHEM?
No.
She's engineering.
I don't even need
she's
this
in,
class.
Yeah.
Is
anyone
taking
OCHEM
at Pierce? Because I need
OCHEM? Who's taking OCHEM at Pierce?
Yeah, I'm taking it at Pierce.
Why?
You're eating up all the oxygen of the classroom.
Makes sense. Just take a look at your hand.
Yeah. Oh, no.
It's not a bit that laughing there.
I were like, never again, yeah.
It just
I would,
nice.
But I want to get my
applications in.
It's like putting something on the resume.
Yeah.
Oh, it's taking the summer.
Mm-hmm.
Taking this. Oh, it's nice. Nice. I thought
it's better to like get it all done.
What? Okay.
Wait and apply later in the year. Yeah.
I don't know, but then you you do 5 weeks of crammed OCHEM.
Well,
I mean,
I'm gonna see how I feel after the first week.
I'm
not saying
it's
fierce.
Yeah.
Just try it out.
Yeah, no, do it.
I mean,
yeah.
If you're doing it every day, it shouldn't be.
No,
too
no, no. I'm not saying
that's
it's
the only thing
he's
doing.
I'm just saying 5 weeks of like all the information.
It's
a lot of information.
It's the
that's
eight
what I mean.
Course.
Oh, 8 weeks. You're good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought it was 5 weeks.
Okay.
5 weeks. That's a lot of information.
Yeah,
I don't
yeah 5 weeks
do
is
do
the winter.
No,
I didn't
want to do 5 weeks.
Thursday.
Thursday.
Trig is just a lot of its own.
Trig is coming up too much.
Formulas after formulas after formulas after formulas.
Like living, breathing 12 hours every day.
That whole double.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
I don't like
the double identities and all that.
It's useful.
Yeah, Trig's very useful. Trig's everywhere.
Trig, you
gotta
hate Trig.
5 weeks? Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
Well,
Trig's not bad. Go ahead, guess. You're trying to scare her.
It's not.
No,
it's just
not.
A lot of formulas.
It's just
a lot
of work.
It's
just
double identities?
Just
remember those.
What if you're really
bad?
I don't know.
Deleted Trig's?
It's
a
Trig's
not
bad.
Yeah.
I feel like
Trig's
not bad.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
Yeah.
Trig's
not
bad. Trig's not bad. Trig's
not
bad. Trig's not bad. Trig's not bad. Trig's not bad. Trig's not bad. Trig's not bad.
Like
if you can, I took a
biosig
sunset
and I found
it.
What, Trig?
Yeah, it's not only memory.
No, Trig's pretty much memory.
No.
Yeah,
so
there's
so
not. Honestly, Trig, you can get by and buy memories in front of this. If you know decent
drawing and stuff.
Yeah,
and
drawing
the pies and
the sign graphs.
Yeah.
You can get by using memory. For most of the class, yeah.
I gotta be, I should have gotten a name.
Trig?
Yeah, but that wasn't hers. I mean, that was hers.
I'm like,
Trig?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I always get A's on my SSL top.
Jeez.
I thought I did enough for an A, but.
What are you going for?
Oh, jeez. I wonder you're doing so much. What's with the internship?
So wait, okay, yeah, you only need one OCAM, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
That's so I'm like,
well,
just do it and get out and be done.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm trying to admit to play, I think both.
Especially if you're not doing it.
Yeah. And some schools don't even care about OCAM, but I just wanted
wait,
to get it done.
Wait,
mm-hmm. K? Yeah, I was going to do PA.
Yeah, that's there. You're good though. It's just a K. It's an equilibrium constant. Why not use it? Yeah. This is your final review.
Yeah.
It's all put together now, so. If you're getting boiling points, what do you do?
If you're getting what?
Oh,
the
like
case? You gotta put it in the case?
So delta equal to zero, and equal to zero. So then we use the delta G equals delta H minus T delta S, right?
Mm-hmm.
Get rid of that. So then T, if you bring that over and divide, it would be delta S over delta H, right?
Yeah.
Nice. So that's how we would do that.
H is.
So now we're actually going to be able to do all of it like interweaved with other topics.
But make sure you turn in joules to kilojoules.
So yeah.
The free energy equal to zero because the boiling point when the H2O liquid is evaporating to gas, they're in equilibrium and therefore delta G is equal to zero.
Yes.
Mm. Yep. At a boiling point or a melting point, you're at an equilibrium point thermodynamically. Yeah. So you can set it equal to zero, and then so any temperature above this would then result in a
fine.
Yeah. So on the if it's like a multiple choice question, cool, you can just bubble your answer. If it's a written question, write like greater than that thing. Just so you don't get like mocked off like a point, right?
Greater than what?
Greater than the temperature, right? Because this it boils at that temperature, but it would at greater temperatures as well that it would be. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. Okay. That's how we do that one. Like Moises said. You can either convert this to kilojoules, or you can convert that to joules.
I think converting
whatever is better for you, right? You have to do it. You do it on either one. Just
but they ask for normal boiling point, so shouldn't it be just?
Oh,
like,
so I'm saying in this case it's just the boiling point.
But if they ask for like at what point does it?
At what temperatures
right.
does
okay.
it boil?
Yeah.
That changes the thing. It's greater than this number then, right? Yeah. So it would be. Let's see. Let's put that in. Let's keep that 93.23. Joules over mole K. And then divided by
0.030
times 10 to the 3, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Joules over mole.
No,
so then these cancel. You're left with Kelvin.
That's going to be like a very
some pretty big number, right?
Yeah.
Oh, they want Celsius? Oh, God. Minus 273.
0.03.
Whatever that number is.
It's bigger.
Wait, you're talking
bigger. Oh, not negative.
Yeah. Wait,
what's up?
Yeah.
That's not going to get you.
to subtract. Wait, that's it.
I got you.
Did I do that right?
Yeah.
No, it's H over S, right?
Yeah.
How about?
Okay. Like,
if
you take
273. I'm like, I got something. No, I just fixed it with an inverse. That's what I did. I meant to do that.
Okay.
Absolutely. Yeah, so there you go. Raise that to the negative 1 and then subtract 73. Merely testing your algebra skills. Yeah, that's what I was doing.
Okay, so it's H over S, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Where was that G0?
So it's 50.
Is that equilibrium? Yeah.
Negative.
Is at equilibrium?
If you're at a boiling point, you're at equilibrium.
Isn't it negative H over S?
No.
Oh, yeah, that was the question I had earlier. Was like,
no, because then you would. So you'd have to multiply that there, right? So you would get T delta S over delta H.
I'm sure you're supposed to do a bunch.
Yeah.
But. Oh, no, okay, I see. I got you. Yeah.
I was too lazy to fix it, so I wrote it to the negative 1 power, so.
But it's kind of nice to work, like, what happens. So you just
count
here, and
then
you multiply
it. Okay.
Yeah.
Formation constant. So KF is that. Not to give you flashbacks when KF, huh? 1.7.
I had a note here from when it was like, oh, the system's doing work, so it's negative.
Oh. Delta G. This is going to be delta G at equilibrium is equal to negative RT LMK, right?
Uh-huh.
Solving for K. Negative delta G over RT, right? Are we solving for T? Yeah. E is equal to K. I'm babying you guys. I'm going to do the algebra in my head. Yeah. So, no. I probably would do it wrong if I did it in my head anyway. Yeah, so then I just divided by RT, right? Mm-hmm. And I wanted to remove the natural log, so I raised both sides to the e power. Mm-hmm. Cool. So that's going to be the equilibrium constant for that. Or we're not solving for delta G, are we?
No, it's delta G.
My bad.
We're solving.
What are we solving for? We're done. That's it then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
we're just done. We're just done. That's it. Just plug it in. Easy. Nice.
So you don't. So your KF is just your K. You don't need to do anything with that.
Nothing.
Only convert to
kilojoules.
Oh, not standard. So
yeah. And then
like
you said, kilojoules. That's it. Yeah. Nothing crazy. It sounds like a scary question though when you do
it.
Right?
It does.
It's like bounce
like
back. Oh shit.
Equation?
No.
And they give you an equation. If they gave us like concentrations, we could solve for K. I guess we could do like an ice table.
Nah.
No.
That's okay.
You want to do an ice table? No?
Even
no,
if you ask me to do it, I'll do it.
That's 8.314, right?
8.314 is? Yeah.
Okay.
Every time.
What? Alright, cool. You need help with math? Cool. I'll be like, yeah, every time.
Oh, this is good. For a particular process, delta G is less than delta H.
That means that S is very large.
So they're talking about S, right?
Yeah.
So it makes sense to isolate S.
Yeah.
Right. So that'd be delta H minus delta G.
Okay. Yeah. So
over
S
T
is very large.
Equals to delta S, right?
Yeah.
Ooh, number five.
S is positive.
Number five is a good question.
S is positive.
In a particular process, delta G is less than delta H. So that means then, well, temperature is going to be in Kelvin, so it's always going to be a positive value, because we really care about it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that means if delta G is what?
Yeah, it's going to be.
Less than delta H, that means then?
It'd be B?
Yeah, B.
It's
B.
What?
So that means H would be, delta H would be large.
But doesn't it depend on the H, though? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what
but
I'm saying. So maybe it's D? I haven't looked at D yet. So.
But if S is positive, if H is negative, then you'd get two negatives, which would make it negative, not positive.
You get a negative and a negative,
yeah.
Bigger negative.
Yeah, so it's not positive.
If delta
yeah.
S is delta S is positive,
mm-hmm.
You get
if
a positive.
Delta H is negative,
no,
so
you
then I'm just reading the question. Yeah. It's negative.
No.
It's negative.
Yeah.
And delta S, wait, is negative and delta S is negative. If H is positive, no, it doesn't have no effect on it, right?
Yeah.
That's a weird.
Wait, no. Yeah, so that would it wouldn't be that one, right?
Yeah.
It'd have to be. So if it's negative, then that makes that
also negative,
right?
Yeah.
And if that's positive, that makes that. Yeah. Okay.
So
you don't even have to use the second equation. You can use just the first one.
Yeah, it's just
yeah.
a way to make it look nice.
Mm-hmm.
I
delta
think it's
S
gotta
is
be B.
Yeah, B.
If S is positive,
uh-huh.
If delta G is less than delta H, that would mean that you're gonna get some value. If we're gonna assume they're both positive, I guess.
If
we assume they're both positive, then yeah, then that makes that positive.
Right.
Yeah.
What
their assumption.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If you make the assumption they're both positive, then yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But I guess that's pretty common,
like,
right?
Which
one positive values, right?
Is delta S bigger than
think about
delta
it.
H?
Yeah. That's the delta S's or the delta?
Because
aren't
they
normally
H
positive?
Might be negative,
right? Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Generally, right. So I guess that makes sense. So if they're both positive, then if delta H is bigger, delta S is that. So then.
Yeah.
That makes sense then, yeah. Okay. Moses said number 5 was good, but.
Oh, yeah, does not change the delta E.
Oh, God.
Does not change the delta E.
Number 5, I guess you said it was decent.
Yeah.
So, doubling the coefficients of all the reactions in an equation for a cell.
Yeah, A.
There's actually, that's. Not correct, yeah, so then let's do it, right? So yeah, so then let's imagine, let's try the E and that, right? So then E node is, well, it relies on N then.
The coefficient.
Yeah, so it does rely on N, which is moles of electrons. F, what is it? Delta G, I bet.
Yeah.
Delta G node.
E.
Is this,
yeah.
Is this positive or negative?
Negative.
So delta G definitely is dependent on the moles, right?
That's the
yeah.
The little circle.
But
E cell?
Yeah.
The E cell.
Sorry.
Yeah, so is
yeah.
E cell.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're both dependent on.
Yeah, and in E cell we have what? E cell
is
what 0.0592 over N
change to delta E.
Log, this is E cell's node, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Is equal to log of K.
Yeah, so they both double.
Oh, snap.
Right? So
yeah.
Yeah, think about it a little more, right? So then
yeah.
they both, it does it double or does it?
I'm saying double because double is the only option. It either says double or it does not change. And it should double because if you double all the coefficients,
I think it doubles G, but
oh, yeah, number 5,
E.
I told you it was a good question,
change.
Huh?
Yeah, it doubles G, but it
wait,
does not change
wait, does doubling the coefficient
E.
change the
electron? So let's do the
oh,
equation.
Oh, wait. No, doubling the coefficients doesn't change the mole, does it?
No.
Wait, no, it does.
Wait,
yeah,
it does change
the
moles.
It does
change
the moles.
It changes N.
Mm-hmm.
So it does change delta G, then.
So it does change it, but E cell is also that.
Wait, no, but I'm...
But
it changes delta G, but doesn't affect.
Yeah, E cell. That's what I would say, because E cell, if you do just E cell by itself, even if you multiply it.
Yeah, the moles of electrons
yeah.
stay constant, I guess, in that case, or no?
Yeah, because I'm guessing once you're at that point, you have the N already set. If you just do E cell, you know, there's a simple add. You don't multiply the first voltages that you get, right? You just keep
yeah, that's
the same.
How I was thinking,
yeah.
too.
Mm. And then you add them, and then this N just stays from whatever from whatever number you get in your moles.
Well, how does that one get affected instead then? How is that any different?
Yeah, they should
sorry.
Both be affected.
Mm. Let's think. So then,
just select
no,
both.
I think.
See if
I, no, I think the idea is that E cell is that kind of property, but then you're still plugging in N.
Yeah.
So that's that. Yeah.
But what if it's
but
not
it did.
That
it did. It did mention that it was.
What if it's not that E cell? What if it's just a basic E cell?
No, but it's their nodes.
That's something Fenton told us. I wrote it on the side.
No, he definitely said. That E cell is not affected by the
wait,
moles.
Wait, but is it?
Oh, wait a minute.
Is it
E cell? All the coefficients, Isn't that would have been still like the same? You can still divide them.
I think we're.
It's still a one to one.
Isn't E cell node cathode minus anode or whatever that formula does says? That's the E cell I'm thinking of when I see that.
But
and
this
then,
is also a valid equation for E cell.
No, but then when you
but
look at
this
E cell,
look at the top.
What does it say? A standard? Doesn't even say a standard condition or anything.
Exactly.
I know, but I'm just saying, like I guess that's the answer, but I don't know that.
No, but look at the first equation.
You see
why
I'm
that equation above?
Yeah, dude, I see what you mean.
It would half it, then, wouldn't it?
If you double the coefficients, won't it cancel anything out? Like when you get
you
down to the bottom?
You can then subtract it, because it's all doubled. It's like a factor of two.
No, I see what you mean.
Yeah, like when you get to the end, will it just end up being the same?
Right.
Or will it actually be the entire thing times?
Like, I know that Fenton says that.
I think, it's just the electron times two. And the it's not the E cell though. When you do E cell, the E cell stays the same. That's what I mean. Like E cell stays the same. But in that equation, that N is still there. So I see what you mean.
Yeah, it won't affect it.
N isn't necessarily.
Because everything is being multiplied times two. It's not just one mole of something.
N is a mole of moles of electrons. Yeah.
Right.
I'm just thinking E cell like in the most basic way possible.
But then if you double G, then if G gets doubled, doesn't it affect E cell as well?
No, but it wouldn't map a change either one.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Meaning,
let's say I double this, that gets doubled, right? But doesn't that mean half this then?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you're just doing the coefficients, right?
I get it. We have to go off the lecture in this case. It says it's independent of the moles.
So then it's A?
It would be.
It's not G. Yeah. No, it's
a.
B. Oh, no. The.
Doubles G,
yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Okay, I have a question on from the C seven.
Yeah, which one?
Number 17.
Did I cat out of it?
It's not telling you you're doubling G, it's telling you you're doubling N, so even in that equation, it's not going to.
Because it's talking about E of the cell as well, and then they give you a bunch of, like a few equations, and some of the coefficients are changed. And I was trying to work the problem, but I was trying to figure out how do they know how many electrons there are?
Yeah. Weird, huh? Yeah, it's, you're going to have to show me after. Yeah. Okay. So, which of the following have the smallest value of K at 288?
Peter. What's up, man?
Dieter.
What's going on? Sorry, it's full.
Oh, wait, that's only for K.
Sorry, the class is full. What'd
you get?
So, E cell. What'd you get? So, it'd be E cell is equal to NFV. Sorry, delta G, right? No? Is it E cell is equal to what? 0.0592, is it?
Yeah.
So which of them would have the smallest value of k at 288? So I think we can just solve for k then, right?
Okay.
So that would be n times e cell. Lowercase. Two equals log of k, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then you'd have to plug it into to the 10th power. So it'd be 10 to the n e cell.
Oh, I see what it's doing.
Whatever. It would be, which one is the smallest value? The one with the bigger number on top, right?
So I guess my question was,
no,
how do you find the number of electrons?
You don't, keep it constant. Just say it's one
just
for each, right?
Say it's one for all of them?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right or no? Yeah, because you don't know how many electrons.
Know,
yeah, you don't
right?
know.
So you just assume they're all the same?
A plus B.
You just keep it constant?
That's
A plus 2B. A plus A, 2C. A plus B, 2C.
Yeah, I think you would.
Yeah,
I mean, how else would you determine
that.
The electrons? You just keep it constant.
Mm-hmm.
You'd have to, you have to assume that.
N is always 1 for all of them.
Yeah.
Okay. That's
unless it's E and you need more information to determine it.
Yeah.
So what's the importance of the coefficients?
I think they're just trying to show you that they're different reactions.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't want to overthink Kaiser's.
But E cell is the same. So, I mean, N's always going to be the same throughout them.
Overthink your test. So then that would mean
Don't do that.
If you want the smallest value of K, you would need a negative big number, right? Yeah, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
OK, Because if you have any positive number, it's going to be big because it's an exponential. Or 10 to that number.
Yeah,
so then it looks like it's going to be
C.
It'll be C in this case, right? Yeah. If you plug in C, it'll bring it 1 over that thing, and then it'll make K very small. Cool. Nice. Well, that's a good question. You're right, though. It does kind of feel like we need more, huh? In that case, yeah.
I feel like it's never more information you need to determine.
Yeah, never ever pick that, because it's too easy.
Yeah.
Well, I guess I'm done then. Because in the gas test, there's one I was like, need more information. Wrong.
No, but I feel like...
No, but you got it right, though, bro. Like, on the KSP
test.
Oh,
actually, I did, yeah. So, haha, jokes on me.
Yeah, dude, he got it right. There was Fenton actually put a question where it was correct to choose the need more information.
I've never.
I was like,
that's not right.
You can compare KSPs if they have the same molar ratios.
Yeah.
And that one it didn't. So I said, you need more information. So that's why I got it right. Nice. But, I mean, Nate's also right too because.
I see my reasoning why I'm wrong.
Why?
I can explain it later.
Okay.
Yeah. I see why I'm wrong. Yeah. I would need to know the concentration of one of the other. Things, yeah. So,
okay.
Anyway, I don't have it, so.
When it comes to chapter 17, it's like into this year, out to that year. So.
Yep.
We're done with that.
If I'm being honest.
So the best approach for these questions when they're asking is to write the equation that they're referring to and then rearrange it to solve for the variable they're asking.
Yeah, you won't get too many of these questions on your test.
And then pray for dear life, you guessed right. Yeah.
That's a mathematical.
Just take the first
what
class.
What makes sense? Yeah. Because even for the other problem, you did the K and the Q. You just switch. You switch it so you can have the K. That's good.
So it's raised to the power of 10. You would want a negative value on top. This is a small value.
Right.
Any other questions or?
Is that like between each other, right? I mean, I imagine it's between each other, right?
No, I feel like
but wouldn't there be multiple ones?
Yeah,
it's the
weird.
Center to negative one. So center to the 2. It's like saying 1 over 10 to the second one. So as this gets larger, it goes closer to 0. So it goes like that on the graph.
Oh, I see. By oxidation numbers, I see. Using oxidation numbers.
Oh, I see, because S can be up to, those have a set. No?
I mean, no, if you make that'd be minus 6, so plus 5, right?
Mm-hmm.
Minus 8, so plus 7, and minus 2. Whereas it's 0, so it can be plus or minus, depending on what you want. Yeah.
I too, right? Yeah.
It's weird.
You have that.
Normally, you would think it's like one of the positive answers, and that's what you have to think about.
What's the question that you thought that was hard? That
oh, so if you have I told Taylor about this question. If you have a cell imaging, whatever. I'm just gonna draw for the sake of this question.
That's the worst.
Yeah, it's pretty bad, huh?
I like how you put the drawing on the. Here, I'm gonna scroll up a bit.
I don't need it. I'm just for
reference.
Yeah, whatever.
Reference
for. That's it. This is zinc. This is copper.
Right.
What happens to the mass of zinc as I get oxidized?
It reduces.
It gets smaller, right?
Yeah.
So on the test, you're gonna have a question: which one is true? The mass of the anode gets smaller, the mass of the cathode gets smaller, and etc.
Mass of the anode.
It's mass of the anode because those zinc, the zinc's turning into ions,
right.
So it's losing.
And it's actually being oxidized here, as you can see the metal as well.
That was a good question because that one took me like.
Let me ask you a question. Which one? Do cations or anions flow to the left or right?
The
in the salt bridge.
Oh,
Oh.
Oh. In the salt bridge, where do the ions flow?
Oh, the other way, to the anode. To the anode.
The negative one will flow to the...
From the cathode to the anode.
Which one's more positive?
The
cations are positive, yes, but the... Yeah, is it the... So it's the cathode, right? It's more positive, right?
Right.
Yeah.
So then the anions go to the right, then. Do you see what I'm saying? In our standard cell that we draw, right? Because anodes are negative, the positive ions will go to the left, towards them, right? You guys are ready.
Yeah.
I mean, not yet, but
no.
You're primed and ready.
Jen, enough your house in my house.
How long is
this? The anode loses mass and the cation gains mass.
Is there until we can't go in?
I mean, if you're thinking about, I mean, if it's being plated, I guess, yeah, it'd be mass, but if it's, that's a good question. Nate, so let's say you had does the cathode gain mass until there fits it? If it's being plated on, then yeah, but what if you have that copper plate already there?
Say it again.
So
I thought they just plate anyway.
Like in this form of
solution, they're sort of like plating on there.
Oh,
okay, yeah.
Is that true?
It does gain, yeah.
Okay.
It does gain
more mass.
Yeah,
I
was just asking if the
anode
loses
mass
and the cathode would gain.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I thought
it
would.
Yeah.
I'm always
just
go ahead. Oh, sweet. So
get the Lagrange
from there. I mean, that's a little plus.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you grab a signing sheet, Moises?
I don't remember.
Yeah. Just over there.
Where?
Mine.
I might have.